Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the EMS One Winter Championship Grand Final for Battlefield 4 in 2014. We're about to crown our first ever EMS One champions for BF4, and I cannot wait for this final to begin. It's going to be a best of five, but before we get there, Ben's with me to discuss the two teams. We're going to take you through the lineups one more time as well. What a fairy tale story for both teams in a way. We highlighted at the very beginning yesterday that MYM were our dark horses for the tournament championship. We told everyone why, and we explained why Dogbert said that he'd seen them in practice and he'd watched them in other tournaments. And he was right. He was absolutely right.
Yep.
And we also had Pyro, who we set up very quickly at the start as the team who were the massive underdogs this weekend out of the eight teams.
A little bit.
Had never reached a quarterfinal in the regular season. Never reached it. I mean, two round of 32 defeats, two round of 16 defeats. They scraped into 16th place by 5 points.
Sounds
barely
painful.
Weren't even in the 16-team group stages. And then suddenly came alive. Added one player. They said that they've added Monster and they came alive. And here they are in the grand final. It's such a fairy tale story that it's almost like I want both of them to win now because they've both got great stories, but we have to have a winner. What's it been like for you watching these two teams come through the bracket?
It's been crazy, you know. MYM, as you said, everyone sort of put as the dark horse. Such a fantastic team, but going into the whole thing, everyone was like, the talk was about Epsilon Fnatic, you know, the big hitters. And I think it just shows that, you know, if you put enough time in and enough practice, you can come out and you can beat the top teams.
Yeah, on your screen right now, the road to the final for Meet Your Makers. It has been a very difficult one. They had Fnatic in Group B, of course. They also had Epsilon in that group, which they had to avoid and get through. They did that. They then made the semi-finals and took down the winners of Group A, who were unbeaten, Team UMAV, and now find themselves in the final. At the other side, Pyrogen, also runners-up in Group A. Neither of the winners of the group have made the grand finals. It's very unusual in any sport, or any esport tournament for that matter, that you see the runners-up both coming through. But they have made it to the final, and it is MYM versus Pyrogen. Now, we're also going to take a look at the lineups as well, just so we can show you the two teams. First of all, MYM, and they will line up like this. They line up with Flax, Punch Ruler, SNF, Waffy, and Ducky Chan. They are the Mavericks of the team, I guess, Ducky Chan. And he's had a really good tournament, I think, overall. I mean, he's had some monster moments, you know, real standout moments, particularly earlier on. Not so much in the semi-final, but more in the game earlier on, they had to beat Epsilon. He was really, really strong. Came up with some massive kill runs, 7 in a row at one point, when he was 7 and 12 for the whole game. And then suddenly, in the space of about 20 seconds, he added 7 in a row, and it was massive for them.
It escalated very quickly. He just went on a rampage. And the key for me is it's not just been individual performances. It's just been consistency as a team. They just look so good, and they really have been producing the best results they possibly can. And, you know, going into this final, they've got to be sat there feeling pretty comfortable.
Yeah. Pyrogen looked like this. Let's take a look at their line. They also have had phenomenal team play. I mean, earlier on, Daniel from DICE said he couldn't really pick out any one player, although I have to say, Hexus has looked very good today.
Oh, he's been
on
plays.
Form. Flashor, obviously, has also stepped up, and Monster has had a great time as well. All of them have had their moments, but collectively as a team, I don't know if we've seen better team play from any other team today.
It's been very well coordinated. I can just imagine some great communication has been down here, you know, when they've been playing. I mean, some of the plays they've made, they've only been allowed to make because of that communication. You saw, like, as you said, Hexus. I mean, some of the stuff he was doing just came down not only to his own individual skill, but the coordination from his teammates as well, which allowed him to make those plays. And that's something which is just so good to see.
Just taking a look at the Pyrogen LDLC players there, and I can tell you there's some nerves down there. I just popped over to have a chat with the two teams. Had a chat outside as well with MYM, and they're pretty calm, they're pretty confident, but they're not taking anything for granted, which is great. But both of them, I have to tell you, look very, very nervous right now. There's a real tension about this final from both teams. In fact, MYM, secretly, I'm going to tell you this as well. We're outside having a bit of a chinwag, just, you know, calming down, and they didn't know it was a best of five final. That's how little they've taken notice of the fact that the final even existed on their radar. So we've just double checked to make sure that both teams know it's a best of five, and now they do. So we're all good in terms of best of five. Incredible, really, that they've had so much focus on their games and their matches that they didn't even realise that it was a best of five final.
That's crazy. Although, I don't know, you know, everyone, including some of the teams, thought that, you know, this could have been a Fnatic Epsilon kind of final, but here they are. They found their way to the grand final. Now they know it's a best of five.
Indeed. That's
obviously going to help just a little bit. But, you know, I think they're going to be ready. You know, just take their time, really okay. compose themselves.
It's time, Ben, oh, to God. Put your reputation on the line in Battlefield 4. It's been very hard to predict these matches. We've got no one left on 100% anymore and haven't had for a couple of games now. But it's time to help out the community because someone is walking away with some monster prizes and you're going to help them by deciding which of these two teams is the prediction. You can predict, make your prediction on this game right now at battlefield-ems1.com. Just scroll down half the page and you'll see the prediction competition, which you can win prizes in. If it's the first time you're doing it, well, still do it because it's fun. And we don't want anyone else to finish on 0% because there are a few of you down there. There are still a few of you down there who are 100% wrong for the entire tournament.
Mr. Kaplan.
But, yeah, indeed. Crazy Kaplan. But there are a few of you at the top end who this matters a great deal. So make sure you get your predictions in. Ben's going to help you by telling you who's going to win.
So I'm a big fan of the fairy tale story. I think it would just be so fitting. Take nothing away from MYM. Fantastic team. Also, kind of that fairy tale, you know, the dark horse rise. But I can see it going 2-2, going to the last map. And the winner is going to be the team that wins the first map.
That's very non-committal of you. All and right. I'm not all sure right, that helps our prediction right, competition.
I'll go with Pyrogen.
Oh, there you go. It's in. There right, good stuff. Well done. Thank you very much, Ben. And thank you for the whole weekend. It's been great having you here in the studios. We will hear from Ben a little bit later on before the end and before we award the trophy and the championship to one of the two teams about to take place in the final. It is a best of five, remember. Hold on to your seats, ladies and gents. Is it Cinderella or is it the Dark Horse? We're about to find out.
You know what, Dogbert? You know what, Red Eye? And you know what, Benson? And to all of you out there watching, I'm going to guess the team right this time. It's the only one that matters to me. But I'm going to wait to hear what you have to say first.
I'm going to go out and say MYM, and I think they might even do it in decisive fashion.
I'm glad you said Meet Your Makers, actually, because I was leaning towards Pyrogen. I'm tired of this whole dark horse whatever shit talking about, because they're not a dark horse anymore if they're in the finals, guys. They're just a horse. But yes, like you heard, it's going to be a best of five. Pyrogen, the Cinderella story, or Cinderella's brother's story, and Meet Your Makers, the team that had a steady decline ever since the beginning of... the season. All both getting to the finals.
Indeed. They've had what some might call a decline, but they've always been very present in all
the top matches.
They're
finishing on a high note.
Very high note. Very, very high note. They're in the finals.
I mean, if I were to talk to you before the beginning of the tournament, if you didn't have any knowledge of the teams in terms of, Meet Your Makers have been really boot camping lately, who would you say would naturally finish first and second?
If I had to go on a limb and say what I did, like, what, two months ago, I would have probably went Fnatic. Just for LAN experience alone would have given him an edge.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wrong.
I think a lot of people out there are wrong, to be honest.
Yeah, and the bans coming in, Paris of Storm and Gorman Railway are out. And Paris of Storm, that's pretty understandable considering MYM not only destroyed pretty much Epsilon, they also destroyed UMAV as well. So that's two of the top heavy hitters in Battlefield 4 that fell apart on Paracel. So insta-ban that one out. Not surprised at all. And we're pretty much going to see the gamut of the entire map pool except from those two maps.
That is very true indeed. And considering we have Siege of Shanghai and Lankang Dam, probably two of the most underplayed or least played maps throughout the season. Surprised to see those in it, but teams have really warmed up to it. And we've seen actually, I think, one of the first times I've ever seen Meet Your Makers play was actually at one like the first cups was on Paracel Storm 2, and you were casting it with Chad.
Yeah, it's been a while, but I'm trying to work out exactly what they're doing.
It's a huddle. Typically in American football, they huddle up. It's usually before a play that they do, and then they discuss strategy, discuss tactics. But for here with the manager, I think they're just doing a little bit of warm-up talk. Like, guys, you got this far. You're doing well. We're going to win this.
And MYM just looked like you.
And he's just the dictator of the team. He's like, you're doing this. You're doing this, and we're winning this game. It's not a democracy. It's a dictatorship.
Well, that's squad-level tactics for you. You've got to have someone calling the shots, otherwise you get a bit of confusion.
It's interesting to see, though, how different teams react to what's going on. Like, for instance, like how they're going to get into a match. You know, Meet Your Makers, one man talking, pretty much. Everyone else just listening right here. Everyone talking. Everyone getting pumped up. Everyone getting hyped. And we're going to get this match underway here in just a second. So Lang Kang Dam.
Yeah, this is...
It's one of the interesting maps for me because it's been very decisive victories on this map.
Yeah.
And it's been all due to just straight up control of A, B, or B, C. And I think we've seen more tri-caps on this map alone than any other. Except maybe...
Power Cell gets a lot.
Yeah.
Power Cell. And so does Zaphod every so often. But the thing about this map is simple. The B flag is just literally the most important. And a matchup I always come back to on this one is UMAV versus MYM. In two separate cups, they played this map. And it's always about the B flag. And both teams would just seem to play a role where one team will capture B first and hold either C or A, and then they will say, well, come and get us. And they will sit there and just defend that flag. Now, sometimes C or the A flag would flicker briefly, but they would get it back eventually. But it was always the B flag that was the most important.
You know what's weird to me is that throughout every time we've seen not Paris of Storm, Lang Kang Dam this entire weekend, we've not seen anyone utilize the roofs.
Yeah, well, the only roof that's allowed is this little ledge here. This one is fully allowed in play, and that gives
you... Wait, what?
Yeah, the...
Because I could have sworn...
Yeah, they were. We.
I did not know the rules were updated for this map.
Yeah, they were updated. So the top of these roofs have been knocked off. Yeah.
No wonder we haven't seen them on the roof then.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah, and this ledge here is the only one that's allowed in play. And that does give a bit of an edge over on the A flag. That is the only place you can
get onto. I just feel like an idiot.
Thank you.
Well, I learned that today. I also learned today that I suck at guessing which teams are going to win. Except the grand finals. I will win this one. But yeah, we're going to see Lang Kang Dam. And I mean, we can look at the entire map pool coming up. Operation Locker. Here, let's do this. Lang Kang Dam, who do you think it favors? What team?
Pyrogen have done very well on this map. They played Dig on this very recently, yesterday, and they smashed them. I mean, it wasn't even a close game. I mean, they really just dominated from the outset, and Dig were constantly playing that game of trying to get B all the time. And, they suffered for it.
All right, Operation Locker. That's the second map.
MYM have a lot of close games on this, and they managed to beat Fnatic on it, obviously, which is a team. But Pyrogen obviously beat Unlocker today. I would say MYM probably a bit stronger on that.
Okay. What about Zavod after that?
Zavod, Pyrogen. But MYM play it quite a bit, but Pyrogen have done quite well in it in the past as well.
And then Dawnbreaker?
Pyrogen have been looking pretty strong on that, but it doesn't matter, but MYM have already just done 230 tickets today alone on that map, so I'm going to go with MYM.
And then, of course, to round out the map pool, Siege of Shanghai.
Siege of Shanghai, that is going to be the wild card, I think. That could go either way. Since the map change and the change of spawns, I really don't know. I've seen MYM play it and not do that great. I haven't really seen much of Pyro on it, so I think that is going to be the wild card map.
I feel like it's interesting between these two teams because, to me, Pyrogen, one of those teams where if they have control, they will just run with it. Meet Your Makers, though, they're one of those teams, to me, at least from when I can remember back in the Cups, that they don't necessarily need control to win the games.
Yeah.
It's a little bit weird sounding, obviously, if you're listening to it. It's like, oh, you don't need control? How do they win? But they don't necessarily depend on the control of the game or the flow of the game.
Yeah, they don't rely on just having momentum.
They can play reactionary and still come out on top.
Yeah, they can go with the tide. They can take it. They can play from behind. They can play from ahead. They can do it all. Pyrogen, they need the early aggression.
They look really...
They need that to start with.
They look, I don't want to say really mediocre, but they don't look like the team we normally see when they're, you know, controlling the pace of the game. And obviously, we'll be kicking this off. It's going to be a best of five here to determine who wins this first place and who comes out. Team UMAV. Forever second. Sorry.
Forever third, fourth now.
Well, yeah, they've dropped. They've gone down. But yeah, to determine, I mean, no one expected really these two teams except, I guess, Mr. Chaloner, Mr. Red Eye, had the Dark Horse Meteor Makers going. I guess you did as well since you were chatting with them. But they're in the grand finals now. They started off on a high note. Can they end on a high note?
I really feel they can. I think they've got a bit of momentum going for them right now. And you got to remember, this is the team, MYM in case, who won the very first ESL Beta Cup. And right now, they are in the final for the very first EMS. And you said they haven't had a championship in a while. Well, I've got a good one they can take today.
Very true indeed, Ari. As we are kicking this one off, we're going to have Meachmakers over on the Chinese side, and we're going to have PowerJet over on the Russian side. And we see three men of each team, actually four on the side of Meachmakers, rushing straight for B here, but this slice is a little crossfire, trying to catch him off guard when they were going with the cross. Unfortunately, doesn't work out too well. I mean, we'll see the fights break out here inside of this B flag. And right now, can't really determine which team really has control of it just yet, but Puntro gets taken down. And that might have solidified here, as you see three men of Meachmakers now falling away. And only, I believe, two on side of PowerGen. But B still has yet to be capped right now.
Everyone in B traded. Everyone died.
No one's even inside the building.
Everyone in B died. And it's going to be MYM trying to pick that up. But meanwhile, they're suffering a fight over at C. It's a one-on-one now with Woffy and Milicium and company. And that is an interesting thought. MYM are going to have to rotate more people to defend the C flag, and wow, right now they've got enough there.
That's a lot of people to commit towards C.
And that's a lot of kills
C
they just got as well. And this is very important. Ducky Chan, last remaining, 3-on-1 for him, and I don't know if he can take this. He needs to be very, very careful. He gets taken out, and there you go. The break has finished pretty much, and PyroGen
wow
with the first bleed.
And two more kills coming right after that, too. And I'm a little bit confused to not have Meachmakers notice that, hey, there's three or four people here. Maybe we should just push A instead.
Yeah, and
they wanted to fight. They didn't want to retreat.
Yeah, they want this C and B hold. That's what they really, really want. And that trade in the middle of B, you really should have gone MYM's way. But they died. Everyone died. No one got the flag. And it left it in limbo. And that gave PyroGen the chance to steal the flag. And right now, this is looking good for them. And if they can't clean up this A flag, which they do, this is good for MYM. It could have been a full domination cap, but they are still going to have a bleed against them.
Poor Flax. The furthest spawn he could possibly have away from everyone. He doesn't respawn on top of anyone. But they are going to be pushing in here. And now this is the moment you're talking about. Just getting beam and say, come and get us. See if you can break our defense. And right now, PyroGen unable to hold on to here. I've taken down Waffy in the hands of Monstro, and they're looking for a couple more. They're watching pretty much every single angle they possibly can. And Meachmakers, you can see them. Well, it looks seems like when someone dies, they're just like, all right, let's regroup. Obviously, can't really take it with the man down if we don't pick anyone off. And right now, with all this time that they're wasting for that, or they're putting into that strategy, they're falling really far behind in tickets.
Yeah, indeed. And that's just how this map breaks down sometimes. And really, MYM's failure to capture that B-flag off the bat has really hurt them now. And PyroGen are running off that. And they are picking off every MYM attacker, and it's not looking good for them at all. But that C flag is open, and this is the chance to bring the game into flux, and that's something MYM need to do, and they need to do it quick.
Yep, instead of hitting that B, looks like they want to go for the backside of C here, and they will have only one man, Ikaho, to defend against us. He sees the flags taken away, he sees B's taken away as well. He's probably asking for a little bit of backup here, but he's just waiting for the push. He's just waiting for C to be captured and then go on the attack. And I would imagine this could actually work out very well in his favor, as you do see lockdown. You just see one man. Puntro, they actually work in for a two-man push, and it actually works out very well. A smart take, not getting too aggressive, being very very patient as well. And just went in for it, capped it over, and they get feedback as well. But they're big fight breaking out inside.
Yeah, and every time MYM manages to pull away a few attackers onto that C flag, they don't make much of an effort onto B. But this is their big chance here, and it goes their way finally. They get the kills, four man on B. No one at A, though. That is wide open. But it doesn't matter, because PyroGen just want to fight at B, and they're going straight head-to-head. Both these teams just standing and banging right now.
Oh, Flasher, he hesitated on that shot. They got taken down, Monstro. And Hexus, well, Hexus came out big early on against Fnatic. You remember his play on Zavod? I know I do. And he's going to be swinging around, coming in for potentially the backside. B will be captured over. Actually, for PyroGen, they got the cleanup. They got the three men that were inside the building. And right now, PyroGen, they are running away with this game. They have a 40-ticket lead here.
Yeah, Ikaho picking off all the defenders on that B flag there and getting the capture. And they're playing exactly how MYM would wanted this game, the C and B. And MYM once again relying on the randomized spawns and getting the furthest ones possible. And that's why the A flag is not a good one to have. And they're constantly stuck. They know full well, but if they can break through to B and hold this flag, they can turn this game around. But right now, PyroGen just have to keep this going.
Oh, they're falling further and further behind now, approaching 60 tickets here, only 5 minutes into the game. And right now, Flasher trying to hold on to this push onto the inside. There's going to be one man towards right, gets the kill on Ducky Chan. It's going to maintain B for a little bit longer with that Ace 52. And again, Meachmaker's going for a hit on a C here. Let's see if they can pull this one off. Safe, going to be coming in through the staircase here in just a second, looking for a man. It's going to be to his right, or his left. And he's taking his time. And I like the patient play But when you're this far down now, I think you're kind of... Patience might not work out for you.
I kind of feel that MYM are probably getting very desperate right now. They know they need to redress this map as quick as possible. And Pyrogen are in just superior positions to defend these flags. And that came off a break, and they've kept this control from the start to the finish. Right now, C, though, is going over to MYM, and the bleed, for the first time in quite a while, is going back over to MYM. And you can already see Pyrogen are rotating to go for that A. They are keeping
tickets.
B.
70.
Yeah.
And they're pushing 80.
They're anchoring themselves on that B flag as much as possible. That's where majority of their spawns are coming in, and that's where they're getting all the kills.
And Flash are getting, wow, a lot of kills. I think that was about three right there, if not assists as well. Stops the push on B. They're going to maintain control of it. They're going to get A for free because no one's there to contest it. And the thing is, they're committing two people to that A push when there's no one there without realizing it. But they can depend on pretty much Flasher alone to hold on to B, it seems.
Yeah, and right now, MYM are just failing to get any of the kills that they need to actually secure these flags. Flax eventually takes down Flasher, who's just been causing so many issues. But their kills are just coming in thick and fast right now. And MYM are looking to suffer possibly the worst defeat they have suffered in this tournament so far. And Pyro are just on top right now.
They are on fire at this point, and it looks like they're still going to try to contest Pierre. Wait for a couple of respawns in as you see Hex is sitting inside this bathroom area. Peeks out, looks for the kill. It's a little bit of damage in there, not picking up the kill just yet. But still, 72 tickets right now. 101 to 30 tickets. We do have a tri-cap, though, in favor of Michi Makers, and the tickets, you can see they are bleeding away. See, going to be capped over here in just a second. Going to give him that superior respawn location. And Hexus, he's just trying to stay alive. He's waiting for a couple of respawns to come in. He's even spraying around corners, pre-frying it. Looks for Ducky-chan. Can't get the shot onto him, but B now being contested here. And all I do is just grab this B back, and I feel like if Mitch Makers in the next 10 seconds, if they do lock B down, that's going to be it. They're going to pretty much not be able to pull any points by themselves.
Yeah, but Hexus eventually goes down. He's been hiding out in the men's bathroom at B for a long, long time, managing to really just hold that flag, and more importantly, it's a spawn point for the rest of the team. While this is going on, though, Safe has been harassing that C flag, and this is giving MYM a chance to possibly get a full domination cap, but Malicium comes in, takes down Waffy, and MYM are doing something that they have done plenty of times on this map before, especially against UMAV, and they find themselves out of position when they are on pretty much the safest place possible. They had B and they had C, but they started rotating too soon, and they pay for it with a flag.
All right, well, 81 takes us to 27 right now. We're going to see things normalize a little bit here. Huntrell does get taken down. That should be C back in favor of Pyrogen. And now with 26 tickets remaining, with Flax the only man alive, as Safe does finally respawn in. I feel like that might be the nail in the coffin. I think that might be the first half going over to, in a very one-sided fashion, to Pyrogen here. But they're still fighting back. They're still doing everything they possibly can here. They have been able to lock down control of B, but they lost A again. It's just an AC hole. I said B because that's what you typically see. But now the tri-cap will be coming in here, and that's got to be it. I mean, just one more hold. That's it. That's all I have to do.
Yeah, there's nothing they can do. MYM have lost this round quite significantly. And what happened to B there was quite evident in this game, in a way, is they were spawning en masse on each other, but they were in such an open spot that they were just surrounded and killed. It's great to spawn on top of your friends, but if you're surrounded by the enemy, you're just going to die. And that is what happened. 80 tickets for Pyrogen, and welcome to Lankan Dam. You get that B hold at the beginning, and you are going to suffer if you cannot break it quick.
Just like the dam in the game.
I didn't even get that one. Maybe subconsciously I just keep trying to get like good puns in there and so on. It just doesn't work. Not aware.
I tried many times in the past and I failed horribly. But you know one thing that didn't fail horribly? Pyrogen's defense right there. Even offense coming out huge. 17-8 for Flasher, 15-8 for Hexus, 13-6 for Malicium, Ikaho 9-9, and of course Monstro, the technically worst on the team, even though they had the highest score, 10-11. That is not a bad record. And then you look on the other side, Mitch Baker's Flax, 11-9, 10-11 for Punch Rule, Safe 9-11, Waffy 8-14, and Ducky Chan 6-15. So not the greatest of starts for Mitch Makers, but obviously as we saw earlier on against Epsilon, they don't really care about a half. They only care about the final half, really.
And you got to understand from MYM's point of view, they were spending most of that time attacking. Mm-hmm. They never really broke through to B. And with that, they're constantly being killed. That's why their kills are never going to be that good. Unless they can break B, they're constantly caught on the move, and they were out of position a lot of the time there, and they suffered for it badly. And it all comes down on this map. If MYM want to win it, they need to get early control. They need to get that B flag. They must feel that they were so close to getting it there. They had a man on the outside of that flag while that fight broke down. They could have captured that B flag, but they wanted to make sure that their victory was complete. And at that time, they didn't have, and Pyro ran away with it, taking that B flag, holding that BC for so long, and really just bled MYM dry.
All right, well, half obviously in the books now with that 80-ticket lead, but Mutual Makers, they can come back here. You see the focus on their faces. They realize what we need to do, grab B, hold it down, and we can really win it from there. But we're going to have our Pyro Jet over on the Chinese side, and now we're going to have Mutual Makers over on the Russian. We're kicking this one off here, and let's see how this game gets developed. I really liked Pyro Jet's play in the beginning, sending that one man to watch the cross to B, but instead Mutual Makers just going to send four straight into that flag and try to lock it down immediately, as we can go ahead and switch over to in-game, I believe, and see how this one really goes here.
Yeah, the man they put on the cross was also caused some crossfire onto that B flag as well. But Pyrogen just got shut down at B. They have two men left on the field. They're all spawning back in. And Pyrogen are not going to give up this fight over B. They are spawning in en masse right now. And MYM are starting to falter, but they're keeping themselves inside the building, and that's where they need to be.
All right, well, I swear to you guys, even though you don't see it on your screen, not exactly sure why, there is a game breaking out, and right now, Mutual Makers do have a 2-1 hold. This is the true definition of shoutcasting, I can tell you that. You guys can't see anything, you just got to listen, close your eyes, and imagine what's going on, because right now, Mutual Makers, with this two flag hold, I'm actually not lost out on a ticket just yet, 150 to 129, and I wonder if it's going to continue to go the way, because they're actually going for a tri-cap here.
Yeah, if they get a tri-cap here, they're going to lose that B flag, but they will get the A and the C, and they will keep this bleed going. And AE tickets is what they got to deal with. It's going to be a hard task, but if there's one team that's going to do it in this matchup, it will be MYM.
Yes, it will, and let's see how this one continues to settle now, as we do have actually Pyrogen. Even though they start on the other side of the map, they're getting a BC hold. And that's where they're comfortable in that first half, and that's where they're going to be comfortable here yet again. And you said 80 tickets. That's not a lot, or that's... That's not a little amount of tickets for them. That is quite a bit, and Mutual Makers have to be very careful. Every move they have to execute has to be perfect, almost flawless. And you see Fasha looks for a couple kills, picks one up on a punch roll, and does defend this flag. He even gets a second, I believe that was. Actually, no, he gets a re-kill onto him as he did get revived, chasing him down, move back away, and you see, I believe that sigh of yours was actually Pyrogen just destroying Mutual Makers over at B.
Yeah, and MYM was so close. He took down, it was a 3-on-1 affair. MYM took down two, but eventually succumbed to the third. And MYM now playing well from behind here. And I'm not even sure what they're going to do, really.
All right, well, we will find out here. As we do actually have Elysium going very, very heavy on this one, doing quite a bit of damage, picking up quite a few kills. And he's able to maintain control of B, it looks like, here in just a second. And right now, we're going to have Pyrogen just maintain control. They're doing a fantastic job. They're evening up the ticket leader here in just a little bit. And they've been fighting with every tooth nail that they could possibly have. And as you can hear through your headsets or speakers, whatever you're using, Pyrogen, there's not too much talking. It's whenever they say something, it's a call, and that's it. To let everyone focus.
That's a lot of shouting.
Oh, they just turned it. I was like, yeah, and it just turned into a lot of shouting. But they seem pumped up, though.
Yeah, but it's because they got the B and C hold right. It's dangerous. It's really dangerous. They're pumped up because they know they just got to hold this out a little longer. MYM are fighting here for this B flag, but none of them are on point to actually capture it right now.
If they don't get it soon.
Yeah, this is getting dangerous. They have like almost 20 or so tickets to play with here. They need to do something quick. There's only one left Flash Orb in B. While this is going on, a C cap is going in effect, and Flash Orb is spawning in some reinforcements, but they are being surrounded. It's still only one guy, and it's Monstro, and he's playing smart, and he's just trying to run here. And Woffy could have possibly cleaned him off there, but the problem was he was a bit worried himself.
I mean, take a look over at A right now as well. Currently, Pyrogen not going to be collapsed upon. And I really wonder what's going on, because Pyrogen just seemed to be completely out-aiming them. Even though the kills show differently, the fact that Mutual Makers doesn't keep one man back to defend against a push kind of shows that they're committing all five people to really lock this down. And if they do win fights, because it's a 5-on-3 or 5-on-4 fight.
Yeah, but that's because MYM are trying to get the B and the C. That's the flags they need more than anything else, and that's the ones they want. And right now they've got finally what they needed, but they don't have many tickets left.
Well, they don't indeed, and we're approaching sub 20 now at this point. And you see them trying to hold on. We have Flax actually very far on the outside, just trying to pick off anyone going on the backside of the map. But as you can see, Monstro picking up a kill right there, pushing in, does get taken down though towards Staircase. And Paragon actually just getting almost completely wiped out right now. Flasher last minute, and he goes down. And I'm at least him spawning in, I believe, actually on top of him goes down as well. So that's going to be a squad wipe. But now, Major Makers, even though, you know, 80 tickets is the point that they have to stay above, they are getting very close to really just controlling this.
Yeah, what, 8 tickets remaining? There's nothing really MYN can really do at this point. They need to be very careful. They need to just keep this hold. They could do something miraculous here. This B and C hold is a very, very strong one, but from Pyrogen's time, they really have all the time in the world to play with here.
Yes, they do, and 18 takes to go here. It seems safe. Let's get the spot onto the man, picks up the kill. And we'll gain and maintain control here. But then again, Hex is coming from the backside, picks up a kill. They actually force him out. And I look what Safe just did. He immediately left when he noticed he was outnumbered, when he noticed he could not hold on to it, went straight for A, and there's going to be no one there to contest it.
Yeah, but they're kind of coming back, and they've been held off by a grenade thrown by Flashall that had nothing to do with the defense of that A flag, and that held 3 people back long enough, but they couldn't get control of that flag. And right now, MYM doing what they can, but this could be a lost cause. They have 6 tickets to play with, make that 5, and every death counts, and none of them are getting revived at all. Every ticket is basically, and that's it. Puntrul's the only one remaining, and he's so far away, there's nothing he can do.
And I think this is pretty much just going to be it. I mean, the spawns, they're getting the random spawns as far as they possibly can away from any sort of map here, as we will have, finally, Paragon lockdown A, lockdown B, and that's pretty much going to be it. 9 tickets remaining. This is the last attack. If Mage Makers don't get this 2-cat back here in the next couple of seconds, that's going to be it. And that will be first map in this best of 5 going to Paragon. Even Ikeho feeling so confident he nades himself.
Yeah, and this is just a struggle for them. And what they're fighting against is not this round, but the previous one. It was so devastating for them, but they have been struggling to recover. This is a very close fought game, and they're taking the lead in it. But the thing is, they lost so heavily in the previous round, but it really doesn't matter. But there's a full domination cap from MYM, but with only 4 tickets remaining, there's very little they can do at this point. But then again, miracles can happen, and MYM just need to keep this B and A hold. They've got 3 tickets. Anyone that spawns in is bringing them even closer, and Pyrogen can use that pack mentality and just surround them and kill them.
Yes, they can. Hex is picking up one right there. Now 3 tickets left to go here. The revive will come in just a second, but that's just going to give him another opportunity to pick up someone else. Actually, does get the revive, picks up the kill either way. Then she does fall, but they're not going to get the revives. That's going to be 4 men down. Waffy, the last man standing, and that is most certainly going to be it. This will be Pyrogen winning the first map in this best of 5. And congratulations yet again to them. I mean, to come out huge like that in the first half alone, with 80 tickets, that is, I don't know, that, I want to say it's almost unheard of for them, but they've been proving me wrong completely the entire weekend.
Yeah, they've been doing a great job, and they've just got, Flashall went huge in that, and so did Hexus. Both of those players have really, really been doing key things in this matchup, and MYM woke up eventually in that second round. They made it a very close thing. They were winning this round, but they were fighting against the past, and their past mistakes were not securing B early enough.
That's deep. Fighting against the past.
It's better than my maths at the moment, so I suddenly realized.
You know me, you know how hard it is for me to do math, but now.
It's much harder for me.
Well, now we will be, though, going ahead to Operation Locker.
Yeah, and Pyro had great game on this already with Fnatic, very close for one as well. And I think if MYM are going to wake up, they'll wake up on Locker. It's a very intense game. I think B on Dam was really the deciding moment in that game. Mm. Now, from then on out, there were plenty of gun battles. It could have secured them possibly that flag. But the failure to catch B on a flag, especially when you're playing the side that should generally get that flag early on, was huge. And the man who did go to the center of a map to try and usually pick off the guy who sneaks around, he was key because he spotted a lot of the people incoming in. More importantly, he managed to do a lot of damage to those people coming into the B flag. Now, that might not be as significant as, say, capturing the flag, but considering everyone in that flag traded, all that damage done paid off in the end.
Very true. And you see Major Makers, though, they don't seem really phased. They seem happy, still seem in high spirits. And, of course, the Red Bull might be helping out with that one.
Yeah.
Might be giving them some wings on top of this. But, you know, it's still a best of 5. It's only one map. Obviously, you can lose 2 and still come back with 3 straight. And right now, Pyrogen, they have to taste it. They have to taste the victory. The thing they've never been able to accomplish except in their group stages where they came out first. I believe it was against Authority and Gamers Connection, but Right now. Actually, I think they believe they beat ESC in the second round. No, it was Gamers Connection. But either way, right now, they have a lot of work cut out for them. They still have two more maps to go here. And Operation Locker, that's going to be a tough one. Obviously, like I said before, they played against Fnatic and did fairly well on it. Actually, they beat Fnatic on that map, considering it's basically Fnatic's home soil, their home turf, their stadium. But now they're going up against Meet Your Makers, which is a completely different play style to me.
Yeah, but also a team that yesterday beat Fnatic on their home turf. So doesn't seem very homely for Fnatic anymore.
Seems more alien to them now.
Yeah, maybe they need to start practicing it maybe a little bit more. But something seems to be going wrong for them. But all those games are not exactly shutouts at all. They are very close. And Locker is one of these maps that really hinges on the B and the A. And sometimes out on the C, but the C flag is one of these ones that really goes down to right place, right time.
Yeah. That sounds about right.
And a lot of teams used to just stick to standard pushes, go out to the sea, and we have those breaks right now, and it looks like Pyrogen are going to stick to the kind of tactics that MYM have been doing on the Russian side, sorry. And just to push through mid.
Well, it's working out for him so far. Able to pick up at least one kill to Wafi, though. We do see him get taken down, and the nice push through the walls actually cleans up another kill. Flax was around the backside, does get the revive on a ducky, though. And we're going to see C contest here with the two-man squad, and they will get the very easy kill to Puncher that will be C-capped over, but they have only one man at A. Ikaho, he's done it at B before, obviously, on the last map on Lion King Dam. But he won't even have to do it this time, because they're actually just going to back away. They're not going to commit for it, because they have Monstro pushing in the backside towards B here. He's forced them onto these back spawns, and he's running such a huge form of distraction that they actually have a tri-cap here in the first 40 seconds.
Yeah, and that's because MYM started to spread themselves so thin. Monstro went massive, got three kills already, and he's just going to run. He doesn't need to do anything. He's just getting more kills. That's four before he was eventually taken down, and he got a flag capture for that. And this is giving Pyro the chance to now just set up a line of defense. They're playing very much like Fnatic here, and MYM finding themselves having to play from behind.
I like where Ikaho is. You never typically look at this position. He's actually going to turn around the corner, pop the health kit down, the med pack. Actually, rush straight on into him, but there's really no one there. I'm even just going to pop a couple grenades on top of that. But right now, you see them holding outside with two men. You see them holding this middle section with just Ikaho, and not to mention you have on the bottom side with Monstro and Milesium to stop anyone from coming in from the south side. So right now, Meteor Maker's being completely controlled, and you don't control a dead horse. Dark horse. Damn it.
They might run off. I don't know. Horses generally seem to get controlled quite regularly.
But not the dark ones.
Maybe not. But maybe Pyrogenesis is a darker horse. I don't know. I don't know how it works. But MYM right now are trying to get finally, they break through, take out Ikaho, who's been such a key player for Pyrogen. And now they're looking to push both A and C at the same time. And this is going to be an interesting one from them. But a game now, which is basically coming down to lots of individual 1v1s.
Well, there was a 1v2 right there where Milesium, unfortunately, did not win. Monstro gets taken out as well. But they trade immediately for B-cap. So able to grab that one. We do need to see someone come out towards C right now, though. Ikaho is going to finally push into that, but it'll just be a little bit too late. But now we see Hexus pushing down towards that south side, looking for some control in A, as Meech Makers do have that two-man setup here. But they have three on the outside, as we do finally see Puncher will come in. And I wonder, can Pyrogen penetrate the defense right now? They do have about a 40-ticket lead already 3 minutes in. 40 tickets won't win you the game right now. They need more than that. They at least need to close this one out here soon. You know, if Meech Makers can hold on to this, if they can defend this, then Pyrogen is going to lose that lead very quickly.
Yeah, but Monstro just went massive once again, clearing off the C flag. Him and Hexus have been doing a great job in this round. Hexus 6-1 right now, and just doing a great job. MYM having much more success on the A flag, but C once again shut down. And now they're finding themselves constantly reacting to Pyrogen pressure here, and I don't know what much they can do. Waffy's already taken down two people on that A flag, more people spawning in, but Pyrogen seem to be getting the edge on this flag. Waffy is a hunted man right now. Reinforcements coming in, kills coming across the board, but A is being massively spawned on by Pyrogen. This might give MYM a chance to capture the C flag, but B is wide open.
You know, you said Monstro is going big. Look at Hexus, 9-1 now. Ridiculous. He almost single-handedly pushed into A, was able to cap on over, and actually going for B as well on top of this. There's actually no one defending A, as we do have the calls come in. They're going to rotate back here, and I want to stick with Hexus, but there's a no man's end right now. There's not going to be any action towards him anytime soon. As Milesium going to be watching the back of A here, and if he just peeks. Oh, They had the spot on him. I was going to say, that was a little bit fishy, but obviously we're on land here. They had the spot. He got the kill through the doorway without even being seen. Does get taken down, though, eventually. But Flashstern out, and A all by himself looking for a kill. Gets naded up. That will be A rotated back here. In the meantime, Hexus again on C on the outside, and they're consistently always ahead of Mutual Makers. They're always one step ahead, and that one step is giving them this giant lead that they now have.
Yeah, but that lead is kind of chipping away slowly, but oh, Flash has spawned in right on top of his teammate Malicium and taking the B flag by storm right now. MYM really, it was up in the air at once and then all of a sudden just went straight back down in Pyro's favor. MYM looking for some sets out on the C side. They'll get that one possibly, but while this is going on, they need to be really worried about pressure coming to A.
Yes, they do, and you see no one. Yeah, you see no one currently at C, and I would imagine that Max is saying no one's coming. Defend C, defend it as well as, or sorry, defend A as well as you can. We're gonna have Mancho push out. There's actually one man above him. He does get taken down here. We actually see three more men. Instead of going A, they're actually countering that strategy. It seems they're actually pushing two more onto the outside. We do see one man fall. Malicium looking for the last kill. Looks like he will be able to pick that one up too, and that will solidify C back for themselves. I like this. This forward thinking that they're applying, they're like realizing that, yeah, they're probably gonna call that we're going A here. They assume that we're going there. But let's just hit C instead. We'll catch them off guard.
Yeah, and you can just hear the Frenchies from here, I can hear them. They're just getting really, really amped up for this game. And this is pushing them further and further ahead right now. And you can just see that the MYM guys are just kind of crumbling here. This pressure that Pyro's putting on them is just very much reminiscent of how UMAV used to play, and just overwhelming. And MYM are just struggling to deal with it right now.
Yes, they are. And you're speaking of hearing the Frenchies. I just wanted to listen in a little bit, really quickly, to see how they're doing this. And they seem so pumped up, full of energy. They realize, you know, we have a big lead here. And a lot of calls going out. And still, they've been able to build up a nice lead. They had a tri-cap for a little bit here. They are going to lose B. They are going to lose, actually, not going to lose B. They're going to maintain control of B here in just a second. But they are going to lose control C. But they are still holding these two caps way longer than Mutual Makers can. You pointed out perfectly. Mutual Makers cannot deal with this pressure that PyroGen keeps throwing at them.
Yeah, and if Pyro were going to take a big chunk out of MYM, it was always going to have to come from a very strong start, and that's what they've had from the first map to the second. And right now, MYM are really, really struggling to deal with this. And it's nothing like the scene we've seen beforehand. And Pyro are just looking on fire right now. They are ready for this, and they are coming ready. They're all over the map.
Again, I want to say Hexagen, because Hex is 15-4 now, leading the entire game in kills, leading the entire game, well, the opposite of leading, I guess the worst in kills, since he currently has 4, that doesn't make sense at all. Anyway, we'll just skip over that, but he's currently the best player right now, 17-4, he's showing no sign of stopping him off the back of him alone. I think this is where PyroGen is really building up their giant lead. 93 now to 30 tickets. He was able to pull it off in Zavod against Fnatic. He was able to do it in that last map. He's doing it yet again here. And he does get taken down finally, but not before solidifying 18 kills for himself.
Yeah, and these fights are just all over the place right now. Flash are the only one left. 5 MYM players all over the place here. The MYM are going to get the A and the B flag. They're going to sacrifice C, and this is their chance here. They need to get this flag capture sorted for a start. Flax is just sitting outside that B flag. They're slowly capturing A. That's where the pressure's coming. They need to get this captured quickly, and they need to start redressing the balance and tickets, and they need to do it quick.
Instead of that, they're going to come in. Actually, we're going to have Waffy get taken down by Ikaho right there. But he's going to continue to push in. He has 55 HP. He's looking to his left, looking to his right, looking for anyone to kill. He gets punch roll. Eventually going to be taken down, I would imagine, here in just a second. But somehow he's still alive. He's going to pick up another kill. They didn't know where he was. Ducky Chan didn't have the vision of him. And this is going to be A side taken over for PyroGen, I want to assume. But it's now a 2-on-2 fight, as we do see Malicium looking for a kill. He cannot pick it up just yet. He's just going to back away. Just going to stay healthy. And now 12 tickets remaining for the side of Mutual Makers. All they need to do is just lock down another 2 cap, and that's going to be it. And right now, it's going to be coming in the side of B here.
Yeah, Flax and Punchroll need to move quick to secure this B flag, but more and more of PyroGen are just spawning in, and they're looking like they're going to overwhelm this B flag. There you go, MYM have been shut out of that. You can see Safe making a feline for that C flag. They need it. They need something. They need to take these tickets away from PyroGen, because they cannot deal with this in the next round. 78 tickets is a massive lead, and once again, MYM seem to slow the game down only when they have very few tickets remaining.
That's the worst time to do that. is definitely the worst time. But we do have Power Gen almost getting fully wiped out, but here it comes. The final push onto A, I want to imagine. Maybe send one back at B. They have three tickets to worry about. All they need is those three kills without revives, but they are starting to lose on a couple of tickets here. Peacemaker is definitely stepping up right now when it counts. Might be a little bit too late. We do have the revive not working. And Peacemakers just have lost three people. They cannot afford to spawn in anymore.
Yeah, they can't afford to spawn in, and there's still a fight going on, and it's all at A. But there you go, MYM do get it, and they still have a chance here to capture this B flag. And what was a very dangerous lead at one point is nowhere near as bad, and this could be sneaky. That is massive! Flak stealing a kill at C that looks so easy to take, and now MYM are threatening a full domination cap. Who would have believed this could have happened? MYM only seemed to wake up at the very end of a game, and wow, they picked a good time to do it in the final, but I still feel that there's nothing they can do to Pyro. There's only three guys for NYM on the board, and Ducky Chan makes one kill. He needs to make a second on A, but right now, what could have been disastrous is only minor inconvenience compared to what it could have been, and that will be it. There's nothing they can do, but 44 tickets from what was almost 100.
Fantastic job. I mean, to both teams. Pyrogen for solidifying that big of a lead and then still coming out with a lead nonetheless, but Major Makers, why can't they wake up like that in the middle of the round, or the beginning of the round? Why can't they just all of a sudden catch them off guard and just play like that? Because if they did, they're looking at a 100 ticket lead for themselves. We saw it obviously earlier. It's not something impossible to them. It's something definitely plausible. But right now, they're still down. They're looking down again, second map in a row after the first half. And if they lose on this one, that will be two maps and we will be on map point.
Yeah.
You said you're expecting a decisive victory here.
Yeah. I guess I got the wrong people.
But you're still half right on that one. And we're going to find out what's going to happen here in the second half in just a few moments. But right now, Hexus, 20-11. 10-9 for Monstro. 15-13 for Ikaho. And then 16-10 on the highest man for Meachmakers is Waffy.
Yeah. And I want to point out Monstro at the beginning of that game. Mm-hmm.
He
basically
controlled it.
Shut down any momentum MYM had out of the gate.
Right.
Took that B flag by himself and got four kills in return. From then on out, Hexus did get loads of kills, and he was and he's the most important player right now. But that initial start that Monster gave Pyrogen has really helped them to get such a lead.
Yeah, very true. And will he be able to do it again here on the US side? We will find out in just a few. And we'll be starting this one up in about 30 seconds. And I want to give you the opportunity. Red, I gave it to me earlier on. Do you want to change your mind on who you think is going to pull out this entire set of games and be the champion?
I think Pyrogen might take this game, and I think MYM will probably take the next one. But either way, this is going to be close, and I wouldn't even be surprised if MYM win this map.
All right. Well, 10 seconds left to go here, and we're going to see if your prediction is true. And right now, Pyrogen, I really wonder what's going on in their heads. Like, obviously not a lot of line experience, none, if any, to be honest. And right now, they're getting ever closer, and I wonder what's going to happen. Will they choke if they do get to that map point? Or will they be able to keep themselves composed? And right now, we do see the first kills already coming in. We actually have Punch Roll rushing straight over towards B. But he does get naded out, does get pushed away. Going to pick up a kill right there onto Hexus. That's definitely a good start for them. They have control of A, but they have lost control of C. They don't own that just yet.
No, and Pyrogen are on the retreat, actually. They have to get back to that B flag as they are being assaulted by Ducky Chan. But he goes down, and that is going to be a safe hold here. That bleed is in the favor of Pyrogen, and this is where it gets dangerous for NYM. They're playing a very fast game here with Pyrogen, but that is something we've seen in the past has favored Pyrogen. So NYM playing with fire here. They're going to get the bleed, and not a bad start for either side, but definitely one that could have done a bit better for NYM, but they do start off with a bleed.
Yes, they do, and it looks like C will be locked down by Meachmakers, so they will have that 2-1 hold. And you can see across your map how they're positioned right now, potentially just looking to stop them from pushing out of this A flag and over towards B or C. They have one man watching outside, another man to back them up if they need. Flax does get that kill. And right now, Pyrogen struggling a little bit to really pull something off. We do have Ikaho going straight for B. He's going to be safe there to really defend against it. Does see him. And he's going to start at least neutralizing here, so they will stop the bleed against either team. But will he cap it over? And it looks like he actually might pull that one off. Yeah, he's going to get it. Safe did get killed on the top side, actually, by Hexus going for the backup.
Yeah, and right now, Pyro or Tricap. Tricap, wow. And they're going to get it. But it's interesting because MYM knew they were being attacked at B and they backed off. They probably assumed there were a lot more attackers than there were. Mm. And because of that, they delayed in defense. And from that, Pyrogen managing to capture C and, more importantly, reinforce A as quick as possible. And there's not a solo push out on C. I don't see how much Flax can do by himself. Saying that, though, kills do come in. Ducky-chan finishes off Flax's hard work and risky work and now pushes that C flag. But Pyrogen are just looking so damn good. Whenever they want a flag, they just take it.
Like taking candy from a baby for them. And right now, they've been building up a little bit of lead. Remember, 44 tickets. Matchmakers drop below that. That will be map 2 in this best of 5. Going over to Pyrogen, and they will be that one step closer to locking down first place here at EMS 1. First season of Battlefield 4. And right now, you're seeing Hexus get taken down. He's not having the best of games so far. And we see him now 3-1. You're going to have Flasher 5-3. On the other side, well, Matchmaker's actually just completely getting wiped out. This might be, no, not a tri-cap, but they're definitely going to get their 2-cap here. And they're also going to get the positioning that they want to lock down and hold on to things.
Yeah, disastrous for MYM Bear. They were caught out in loads of position. Massive spawn on B. This will favor them, though. But they need to clean up this pyro defense quick as possible because that C flag is completely open right now. They need to finish off these defenders. Malicium, last guy left. And hopefully they know he's there. There they are. Take him down. C is wide open. And with that spawn from Monstro, he'll take it. And his opposite number is going to be Ducky-chan in defense. MYM here, they have 100 tickets. They are basically playing almost against 150 or plus ticket team right now because of the previous round, finding themselves behind once again and stabilizing the game.
Well, they've been doing a good job of that at least, and they're still in take control of C though. I don't know for how long, as Malicium does go for that very wide push onto it. Gonna be able to hold onto that one, as you do see Ducky-chan forced to back away. Though Safe does get the revive, and they're looking for that first kill, but another one comes in from the side of Pyrogen. They're able to maintain control of C. They're gonna have that 2-cap. Even Flax giving it a go here. Looking to pick up one, does get taken down, but she actually trades a 1-for-1 in that one. But that obviously is gonna favor Pyrogen here though. Look at Malicium. He's being sneaky as hell. He does get taken down though, so he won't maintain control of C. But this should allow the rest of Pyrogen to immediately go for the push on a B, and that's exactly what they're doing now. Monstro in the prime position to pick up these 2 kills of men that are right above him. Come to the side, but he gets taken down from the staircase. Meteor Makers have started to step up.
Yeah, where was Meteor Makers like this in the first round? That's what they needed to actually make this a little closer than it is. And right now, once again, MYM are playing against the previous round. And they have the bleed once again. Far more control than in the previous one, but here you go. I mean, Pyrogen, when they go on the attack, they just seem to get the flag they want. And if at this point, they cannot, MYM cannot afford a close game.
They definitely cannot. Not to mention, just for team morale overall, if you're 2 maps down, going to the potentially final one, it's going to be very hard. Even the most experienced teams have a tough time really dealing with that pressure. And right now you're seeing Pyrogen, they're going to grab control of C, but they have no one at A. And look at Malicium immediately going for a push right on to B with Monstro coming in from him, in for it as well. They completely just read Meteor Makers. But look at this, Flax actually pushed through. Did he get the kill onto C? He's going to pick that one up.
So
and he
sneaky.
Just turned that one around.
So sneaky. He made it look like he was going one way and then went the other. And then he gets the flag. And this is the position that MYM need. They need to hold this A flag, though. And spawns are coming in. More people from Pyrogen are coming into this flag. And already they're losing slight control of it. And those spawns on both teams. And this is just reminding me of Damn. Spawning on top of each other on the same flag. Just trying to get dominant sumo wrestlers on a flag. And MYM pick it up, but Pyrogen just switch their attack and play classic Battlefield and just take the one that's undefended.
And it's working out very well for them so far, even though we're pretty much having right now Pyrogen down on tickets. They still have quite a few to work with here. They need to catch up to Meteor Makers. They need to get this 2-cap hold if they do want to make something happen, but Meteor Makers seem to be that step ahead. Oh, look where Wafi is. I have to say, if he missed that kill, I would have probably eaten my shoe. But he gets the one on the Flasher and just stopped any sort of push coming in towards this A flag from the backside. Monstro, though, going to give it a go. He does know exactly where he is, does spot him out. Is he going to get the spray? Yes, he does. And that does open up potential push onto A here. But every time Pyrogen move into another flag, they get shut down here. They're losing the one-on-ones. They're losing the two-on-ones that they have in their favor. And Matchmakers have carried over their momentum from that first half towards the end of it.
Yeah, but they're being wiped out today once again, and this is worrying here. They had a chance to catch them from behind, and they didn't take it. But it doesn't matter. Black's last guy remaining gets the kills, and they hold the A flag, but B is wide open, and those spawns are going to be so close. I doubt they can do anything about it, but they got a spawn outside of C, and I think they should make the most of this. If they go for this B flag, it's going to be an uphill one. This is a possibility that MYM can come back here, but they need to play smart.
Ducky Gen knocked down, very low on health there from Grenades. We actually see some coming around from the side. He's going to drop down. He's going to get the kill. Going to get the revive from Monster right there. And Meat Makers only have two people alive. And now look at Pyrogen immediately going for push on A. They shut down the push on B by Meat Makers. And this should be, I want to imagine, a two cap finally going back up for Pyrogen. But then just as I start saying that, Puntro gets the back spawn.
Yeah, that spawn at B is very regular.
Oh,
that's
Monstro.
Why that flag.
If he can stop this.
It's the only one who can. And he knows where he is, and he's throwing those nades. This is the worry about that flag. You don't know which direction they're coming down from.
Oh,
but he didn't get it.
Punch coming up big right there. Gets the kill. But now the rest of Pyrogen and closing in on top of him. But then again, Meachmaker's getting spawns in on towards B. We do have one man pushing on to C currently for Pyrogen on the top side. See Milicium pick up the kill. And that will be B clean up here in just a second. I want to imagine. I want to focus on outside though. Flasher, will he get the better of him taken? And will he hold on to this one? And right now the man's right on the staircase looking for the kill. He's spraying it down, but he gets taken down either way. And Pyrogen going to get control of B and A, but no one spawned at A at the moment. And this is a very bad position if you're a Pyrogen fan. 32 to 66 tickets. They need to drain off another 20 here if they want to secure this win on this map number 2. And they're giving it all here, but Tex getting flung into the wall.
Yeah, and Puntro here and Woffy need to move quick to get this A flag. They know pressure will come at C and A, and Pyrogen here are going to be the ones to decide the fate of this map as they're attacking across the board. Maybe a bit risky to do it. They could just go for an overwhelming attack, but they choose not to, and it's a one-on-one. It goes Pyrogen's way. That is huge. That is going to give them the bleed, and that might be the most decisive move this matchup.
I love the spawn by Ikaho on top of Milicium. They expect something to come towards B. They sense something, they smell something, and it looks like they're going to read into it perfectly as Meachmakers was making that push, and they're still going to continue to come in here. Ikaho actually going to run right under some one man of Meachmakers. Get taken out from the side though. If they can hold on to this, with Milicium come from the backside, this might be it. 51 tickets are out. Currently 44 is that threshold, and they have 20 tickets left. A lot of the flags are under contention here. C going in the favor of Meachmakers, but look at this. No one's on A. They're going to push straight into it here, but then again, Meachmakers is back capping onto B at the same time.
Yeah, this is the chance that MYM need, but every ticket counts right now. Everyone needs to get revived, and MYM are finding themselves all over the map here. They need to make sure they keep this B flag, and they're so out of position, but they're getting the kills though. That's what matters. This is what matters in Battlefield. If you can get kills like this, you will win the game, and they're bringing them back to 10 tickets to 48, and MYM are going to get a full cap in the dying seconds of this map. 5 tickets remaining, and there's no way Pyrogen can get out of the tunnel. They're stuck in there, and MYM have just had a fighting retreat at Gottmouth map. Wow. There's nothing they can do. Oh, wow.
48 tickets. They had 4 more before that would have been it. And they hold on at the last few seconds, taking map number 2 here. Now we're going to be all tied up here, 1-1 in this best of 5. This proved to be a pretty good finals. I was about to say, after that first map, I was like, wow, this is going to be a stomp. But very close map. Meachmaker's pulling out ahead in the end. And that means now we're going to be going on to Zavod here as our third map. You're still speechless.
Yeah, pretty much. Ducky-chan, 18 for 1.
Wait, Ducky-chan, 18 for 1. He's 21-8.
21-8. What did I say?
18 for 1.
Yeah, I'm wrong.
That would have been impressive.
But Flax, he seems to make... I don't know what he does, but he always seems at the top of the scoreboard whenever Locker gets played. He just seems to do something that always seems to be in the right place, right time. Out at sea a lot, and sees where they won that fight. Like, all the time they were back and forth between A and B a lot of the time, but there were one-on-ones, two-on-ones at sea, and with that, they took it. And they just stopped any momentum that Pyrogen had from the first map.
Just wow at the end of that one. I mean, Flasher, he came in from the backside towards B, towards the dead end of it, and he killed one man, but then he was in a faded 1v1, and that's where you really freaked out, because he got taken down. If he would have gotten that kill, they would have solidified B, they would have won that map.
Yeah, and the thing that gets me about Pyrogen is we have seen this before. Against Dignitas, they were way ahead a lot of the time, and then all of a sudden it just collapsed like a house of cards. Dignitas would start taking them out one at a time, and it would just be like, oh my god, is Pyrogen going to throw this away?
And, well, they did on that one.
And that's what happened there. And a lead that they had just got sucked away slowly but surely and MYM just took it with four tickets.
Yeah, fantastic play to them. And now, Zavod, you kind of gave this map, I believe, if I remember correctly, to Pyrogen.
Shanghai, I think this is the wild card map.
We shouldn't be going to Shanghai. We should be going to Zavod, if I remember correctly. That is the correct order.
I just seen it load up. I'm just like, oh, God, no.
We're already into the final match.
Now, here we go.
We should be going to, I believe, a quick little break with Red Eye, but I believe we should be going to Zavod in just a few. And that's going to be an interesting map because we've seen both teams perform well. I believe it was Meachmakers getting a giant lead against... No, actually went down to Epsilon, I believe, earlier on Zavod. But this is a map that both teams know inside out. This is one of the most played maps, I think, across the board for every team in the entire season. I wonder how this one's going to work out, especially with the momentum. This break obviously might change things up a little bit. It might give Pyrogen a little bit of time to, you know, figure out what they did wrong. It might cool Meachmakers down. It might pump them up even more. Time's going to tell.
Yeah, we're going to see. And Zavod's just played so much. And we've seen against Fnatic... Hexus's play was amazing.
It was.
Picking his moment to shine, and Fnatic couldn't respond, and that shut them out. That you could see them just disheartened from that one out.
Very true.
Threw them out of the tournament. and full of surprises, Pyrogen. But MYM, you know, got to look out for them. They can do that. They can come from that far behind and take.
Can
the
they
game.
Do that?
They can do that.
Do it. We will find out, obviously, a little bit later on Zavod, but for now, we're going to head over to Red Eye and Benson for a little bit of talk on the past two matches.
They can do that, they can. They can definitely do that. Thank you, guys. Some fun commentary in there. It's a great end to our second map. We're going to do something fun in just a moment. Ben is with me. We're going to talk about the first two maps as well in a moment, but before we get to that, we want to give away... our prize for, yes, thank you, resplendent as it is in all its glory, is the Astro A50 wireless headset. Now, I'm going to let you into a little secret. I'm not a closet nerd. I'm a full-blown nerd. If you ask me what I do on a train, I tell you. And I'm very proud of being a nerd and a geek. And I have to tell you, I would love to have one of these because it's wireless, which means, like, imagine the scenario. You're in the middle of a Battlefield 4 game, and you die, and you're like, oh, damn it, okay. I'm just going to get a drink, guys. Normally, it's like headset off, puts down, you go and get a drink, you come back, you put your headset on, and they're like, where did you go? Like, what the hell's going on? Now, yeah, that's right. By the power of Astro A50, you can leave your headset on, walk to the kitchen, make a cup of tea, come back, and you haven't missed a single bit of comms, and they don't know that you haven't spawned back in. It really appeals to the nerd in me. However, we're going to give one away, and we're going to give one away to the winner of our fan art competition. Now, there's a little bit of a story behind this, okay? Yesterday, yeah, let's show you the winner. Let's show you the picture. Okay, so that's our picture. Now, bear in mind, there's two reasons that we've picked this one out, okay? The first is, that scenario happens to me in Battlefield an awful lot, right? And way too much. I am literally on the beach, firing inland, and everyone starts to scatter. And I'm like, ah, yeah, that's right, run away. And I turn around, and oh, crap, it's the boat, damn it. And I'm dead. So that's why it appeals to me. But it also has a really cool story to it. The guy that drew this yesterday was at home watching the stream, watching Battlefield 4, drew it, and then today got on a train and came all the way to Cologne, all the way to the studio, to watch the games live. How cool is that? So, Marcel... where are you? Come here, Marcel. Yeah, you're not getting away with it. Come on, Marcel. Come here. This one's yours, sir. There you go. All right? You don't have to talk. You don't have to worry. You're famous now. Internet fame for 15 minutes. All good?
Yeah, thanks.
Having a good time?
Yeah, really good.
Good. Okay. I'm really pleased for you. Marcel, well done. There we go. See, that's how easy it is we give away our stuff. For really cool stuff that you guys produce. Thank you so much for all your submissions as well over the weekend and for taking part in the prediction competition, which will also crown a winner and give away some free prizes. Ben, serious business now.
Down to the serious stuff.
Space now. What a couple of maps.
Crazy.
First map, you know, Pyro, really, really solid, straightforward. It's almost like it's exactly where they left off in the semi-finals. It's just carried on with that, you know, ruthless determination that they have with that clinical precision on all the points. But then something magical happened to NYM in the second half of map two.
Yeah, it's pretty intense. And it was good to be sat watching it because everyone was kind of going, oh, and you could hear everyone counting down four, three tickets left, two tickets left. Oh, he can't spawn in. And you have to give NYM some serious props. I mean, that was a serious comeback. It was really good to see. But Last time I was stood here with you, I said the winner of the first map is going to take the series.
You did.
I said Pyrogen were going to win. Pyrogen also won that first map. And for me, the big thing now is, can they shut down the MYM momentum? Because it's, I mean, everyone heard it. They were loud when they won. They get really pumped and hyped. So Pyrogen need to find a way now of just shutting that down.
All right. Thank you very much, Ben. We're going to go back to our commentary team in just a moment. The teams I can see are all back in position again. So, ladies and gents, enjoy the rest of the grand final. We do potentially have still three more maps to go. Who's going to take it, MYM or Pyrogen? Let's find out.
Well, we will find out here momentarily as... Honestly, I couldn't tell you which team's really going to pull this one off. There's been a lot of back and forth. There's been Mutualmakers really stepping up. It took them a little bit to really wake up. And we'll see what's going to happen as they face off against Pyrogen on Zavod. One of the more most played maps throughout this weekend, but also one of the most surprising maps as well.
Yeah, definitely. Pyro did a great job on this map against Fnatic. They really did hurt them. And it was all about Hexus and really just keeping Fnatic off balance.
Yeah, very true indeed. And let's see if they can keep that going, because right now it's at the point where they need to pull out another map here. I mean, Pyrogen, if they lose on this one, I think the momentum will have shifted so far against them that when we come into Dawnbreaker, they won't really be able to do anything.
Yeah, and it's going to be a difficult one in a way, because I've seen MYM play this map quite a lot, and especially recently, and they have made some
biased.
Big mistakes.
Yeah, yes, they have.
And they have been punished for it badly. And I got a feeling Pyrogen might take this map. I really do.
All right, well, we will find out here momentarily as we're going to get this game underway very shortly. All teams have their quick little break. You know what's funny? The headset that Red Eye just gave out, there's actually no headset inside. He took it home with him. He just gave him a box. He cut a deal. He's like, if you come to Cologne, I'll give you an Astro headset. Wink.
I wouldn't be surprised if you do that. Not at all.
That, hey, not me. Red Eye.
I wouldn't be surprised if he did that.
Okay, I'm about to say. That's.
I'm not surprised.
But don't worry. There's actually no keyboard in there either. In the Battlefield Black Widow.
Did you?
I'd be at home already.
You do look a bit shifty sometimes. I'm not surprised.
I take offense to that, sir. I look shifty all the time, not sometimes. Get it right. But Zavod, like you said, get into that one. We will be following that one up with Dawnbreaker, but we're tied currently 1-1 between the two teams. And you said yourself, Mutualmakers, they've been making a lot of mistakes. And there's some interesting things going on your screen as I was looking over. They make a lot of mistakes, but I don't think they make mistakes this time. They know what they need to do. They've seen what they've done in the past. They've had their manager here talking with them. Something's gonna change this time, and I believe we're going to get underway and live here in just a second. And we're going to have over on the Russian side, Mutualmakers, over on the U.S. side. It's going to be Pyrogen, and we are going to see it kicked off the bat. Actually, no one on Mutualmakers contesting B.
Wow.
They are rushing straight towards C and leaving one map back a day.
Yeah, I don't know if I like this, but let's see how it pays off. It all comes down to that 1v1 over that A flag. Because if Hexus can get that kill on that A flag, then all that effort is going to be for nothing. And he goes down, Waffy gets the kill, only Englishman to make it to this tournament. And there you go. It pays off. Two flag hold.
Wait, there's people from the UK that are good at games?
Oh, I take a lot of offense to that.
Well, you weren't good, though. But right now, Pyrogen going to be attacking C yet again. Mutualmakers, that early little bit of play that they pulled off worked out for them very well. They read into Pyrogen, because right now they have that 2-5 control. But Pyrogen, they're going to fight back. They're going to attack C here momentarily, I would imagine. And Mutualmakers, they are off to a very strong start, which they have not had in their first two maps.
Yeah, not at all. And holding the C flag by himself, but giving time for MYM to pressure that B flag and bring a rotator back to A to defend. Ducky can just sneak into that C flag whenever he feels like, and there you go. And this might catch... This game is going to go into flux now.
That's typically what I expect out of like the first couple of minutes of it right now. But right now, you see Doug Chan looking to crap C. Looks like he should be able to pull that one off too. But he has Pyrogen swarming all over him. He picks up one kill, looking for potentially second as this. Actually, the guy is under, gets killed. And that will be C, I would imagine, here as Monster. Actually, no, C, with Monster going down, will be maintained by Mutualmakers. Even if the revives in on top of that, they have a 2-1 hold, and they have almost 20 ticket advantage here in the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, a good start from them, but at the same time, Pyro have been getting a lot of important kills, and they get a second one there, and their third, and Ikeno getting a kill on an unsuspecting opponent, and more importantly, the guy who spawned on top of them, and that's going to give them their first bleed of the game. And MYM here, kind of stuck with a man on each flag, but with a defender there as well. B will go over, but they lose C, but they're going to capture A. Back and forth game, straight off the bat.
Yeah, very back and forth right now, and we just see Powerchin trying to hold on to A. We see Ikaho trying to fight for it, but it's going to be neutralized. He's going to actually keep continuing. If I gets a kill on the punch roll in the end, the 1-for-1 trade, but Hexus now, he's looking for some control here. And he's looking to go big like he did against Fnatic a little bit earlier on today. I'm just actually tag along with him. He is off to the side inside of this A flag. And it looks like the opponent on the other team actually won't contest it. He's going to back away.
Smart move.
And that will be A given over to them, as well as C. And now here's the time. Can they get set up quick enough? Can they get in the right position that they need to? Can they be at the right time, at the right place to pick up these kills to stop Meteorikers from rushing in? Because MYM so far on this map, every time they wanted a flag, they took it.
Indeed, and MYM need to get this C flag, but their push on this flag has took so long. Everyone has rotated in back from A. Spawns are coming in, but because the spawns are on top of each other, it's an easy one to pick off. And still, they're going to lose all the flags, and they need to win the C flag or a full domination will happen. There you go, they get C, but they have the bleed against them. And a lead, which was significant, is now pretty much dead even.
Right now, Powerchin have no one at A. But Meteorikers don't really expect it. Waffy, he's kind of sniffing something out, but Powerchin are able to hold on to, I think, C. It looks like they have B as well. They have a tri-cap for just a little bit as A finally being contested here, finally being turned over. Now, just as quick as Meteorikers got that early lead, is as quick as that lead disappeared, and now Powerchin are threatening to take that lead themselves.
Yeah, this is going to be a back and forth game. Going to be like the UMAV one before it, but right now, Pyrogen seem to be getting more of the kills, and that's going to be really worrying for MYM. If they can't make their pushes work on the small ones, they're not going to have any luck on the bigger ones, and right now, this push on B is looking bad.
Flashor, though, single-handedly shutting that down, picking up two big kills. He came in from the backside, stopped the entire push on B, looking for the third one. He gets it, and that is going to be him finally taken down, but not before taking down three people, and then Monster come up with the final kill. They have shut that down. They're going to get a tri-cap off of this, and Meteormaker's getting respawns in the middle of the map. Very dangerous. That was a very bad position to be in, and now Meteormakers are fighting an uphill battle to stop that one mistake from ruining their entire first half.
Yeah, and that's what happens. You get caught out in the open near B. It's a death trap of epic proportions, and right now it's just Flax by himself. No spawn's going to come in.
Wow.
And if he goes down as well, which he will, and the rest of the team follows suit, a full wipe for MYM and Pyrogen looking strong now. 106 with a ticket. A full domination cap, and more importantly, any chance to get A is getting frustrated as they're constantly under attack. And this is a repeat of what happened with Pyrogen against Fnatic.
They're not even getting A right now. They're taking so long to go for it. They need some sort of flag back for themselves, and they're finally starting to cap it over here. And I was actually curious where Hexus was, seeing if he was going to fight that one out here, but it looks like Malicium just going to back away, play cautiously, control C, not too worried about that tri-cap. Yeah, they'll take it if they have the opportunity for it. But right now, they realize we don't. We're going to back away. And we're going to maintain this C-hole. They've been doing a fantastic job of it so far.
Yeah, and majority of success coming from Pyrogen is their positions. They are in positions to just outfrag. They are already they're always catching MYM on the move. And at no point really is MYM in a safe place to get any kills. So they're constantly just being caught from the side, from the rear. Never, ever in a good position.
Look at this difference in tickets now. We had a 20-ticket lead for Meteormakers. That has disappeared and actually multiplied against them. 60 ticket difference now between the two teams in favor of Pyrogen, and they're still full control of this game. Look at this. They're getting a tri-cap yet again here. They have Meteormakers so far on the back foot that they just have a huge lead built up, and I don't think they're going to lose this. I don't think there's really any chance for them to lose this giant momentum that they've been able to accumulate.
Yeah, and this is something that's already happened to MYM on this map. They just seem to have this collapse. This happened to them against Fnatic yesterday, and they're really, really just repeating the same mistakes, just being caught constantly on that A flag, never seeming to have any success at C, and right now, Pyro just looking so strong.
They are looking ridiculously strong. As you do have Lisa to be sitting inside that tank, making sure no one's going to be pushing in. Flax, can I just back away? Not feeling too confident at that push onto C here. Might get a little bit of a back. Actually, does have the back spot on him. He does see them there, but they don't get any kills. He hasn't picked up one kill just yet. He's gotten two people down to like about 10 health, but hasn't actually solidified a kill yet. He still goes down without picking up anyone. And Pyrogen, main take control of B here. We do see Monstro in a one-on-one. Actually, well, not a one anymore as they do pick up the kill. They still have the tri-cap here. 96 to 9 tickets. This is definitely going to be it. This will be the first half going over to Pyrogen, but who knows the ticket lead? That's what for me. That's for a question for Meteormakers to answer.
Yeah, and they need to do it quickly here. They need to redress this balance as quick as possible, and they
can't.
94, big lead. And something, it just seems to happen. And most importantly, once again, everyone might be talking about Hexus, but Monstro, once again, the guy getting kills but gets the flags.
16-8 for him.
Yep, big score.
12-9 for Hexus, 12-8 for Ikaho. On the other side, though, Flax, 3-12. 5-10 for Waffy. And the person that had the most kills, 11-16 for Punch Rule.
And the team caught moving between flags a lot of the time, and that is going to reflect in the kills and deaths. As soon as Pyro were able to get their B and the C, they were able to just really play the game the way they wanted. One or two full caps, and then from then on out, MYM were in trouble.
All right, well, obviously anything is possible in this game, but do you legitimately think that Meech Makers can pull this one back?
94 tickets.
It's a lot of tickets.
That is a large amount of tickets. I think that's almost impossible.
All right, and that mean they should be looking forward to Dawnbreaker? Probably start talking some things. Obviously, they're going to give it a go in the beginning. I think if they get initially two capped and they can't take it back right then, I think they should be like, all right, well, that's going to be it. Let's just start talking about Dawnbreaker, because they won't have a pause between this game and the next. They will have one if they do take, if it does go 2-2, obviously. But that's obviously another map away. So the Dark Horse, did it break its ankle? Does it need to be shot and put down? Or is it going to continue to thrive and maybe become a thoroughbred?
I think that one's down to Pyrogen.
I'm just thinking of really bad things right now. But we're going to obviously have the second half here starting in just a second. Meech Maker is going to be over on the U.S. side. Pyrogen over on the Russian. 10 seconds to go here. We're going to find out. Can Pyrogen shut this map out very quickly? I mean, obviously in the first map that they did win, it was 80 tickets. Of a lead, and now they have 94, very similar to Lankang Dam, but obviously it's not over just yet, and we do have this one kicking off here. Meech Makers, what are they going to do? They went for a very ballsy play in the beginning, sending four men straight towards C, but it obviously didn't really work out too well for them. It did work out well for them, but in the end, they just couldn't compete with it.
Yeah, they couldn't maintain that at all, and I don't know, it's standard start for them. Everything went well for them at the beginning, but in this one, nothing is going that well for them. They've already lost one man down in the center of the map, and right now, Hex is coming straight through the center, unmatched at all, and he gets a kill, and he's pressuring C already. How many kills is he on? He's on 3-1 right now, and he's causing so much damage straight off the bat, and Pyrogen are threatening a full dom cap right away.
And I would say with that, it's going to be like, oh, yep, all right, we played well, guys, we tried. Let's start thinking about Dawnbreaker, because Malisium, he's still there as well. Picks up another kill. That will be C, capped over, and B in the meantime. Let's go ahead and check that one out. I'm going to zoom across the map. We do have two men on the side of Pyrogen there, and two on the side of Meech Makers. Who's going to pick up the kills, though? That's the real question. You do have respawns coming in, but Pyrogen are just overwhelming them. They get the kills. They're going to get control of B here, and this, it's not going to be the nail in the coffin just yet, but it's another straw on that camel's back.
Yeah, it's really, really bad for MYM now. Once again, relegated to the A flag, the one they definitely do not want, and a flag that they generally could probably call their own after 2 days of action. They just seem to always end up on A on this map, and there's not seem to be much they can do to rectify that. And Pyrogen are just coming forward for frags. That's all they care about right now.
That's all they need.
That's all they need, yeah.
They're like, they can treat this as a TDM, not really care about the flags right now. And even by doing that, they still have a BC hold anyway. So they're winning on all fronts of this. And currently, 117 tickets, another 20 to go. And that will be it here for Meech Makers on the third map of this best of three. And then we'll take it to a 2-1 score for Pyrogen here. And Monstro, you mentioned him for both maps now, as well as Hexus. They are showing no signs of stopping. Like, they are only getting better as every map progresses.
Yeah, and right now, MYM might as well just get ready for the next map. They're just stuck in the middle of the map and not really doing much about it. And Pyro are just hunting them down and fragging. And once again, a bad first round bites MYM in the ass. And forced to a second map, fourth map.
I know, it's our first best of five, and it kind of plays with our mind.
Plays with that my sound. Mind. I'm trying to work it out.
That sound was your brain just dying.
Exploded.
Well, Pyrogen, there you go. Two maps up to one, and we're going to be heading now to Dawnbreaker here. There's not much more to say about Zavod, except they just played damn well and held onto those maps those flags without losing them. But now Dawnbreaker, that's the tricky map. As you said before, it's the Heartbreaker map. Will it heartbreak Meech Makers into a loss and give a big joy and excitement to Pyrogen for winning first in their first time ever?
Well, what's going to get me about this is we've seen Pyro play Dawnbreaker against Dignitas twice. Mm-hmm. And both times, even though they won both of them, it was really close. Mm-hmm.
What worries me is that Paragon, their aim has been ridiculous.
Yeah, this, I don't know set. What they've done today, but all of a sudden...
They ate their Wheaties. Yeah. I don't know if the hotel serves it, but whatever that German breakfast was, it is working well with their bodies because they are a lean, mean, killing machine. Yeah, a little bit of George Foreman in there. It's overwhelming. It really is. Hexus and Monstro have been consistently good all day long.
And you can see it in the MYN guys here. They're just frustrated. I think that's, if anything, what it is. They're really frustrated. They know they're a top team. They know they can beat Pyrogen, but it's not coming out in their play.
Mm-hmm.
And that's frustrating. And smiles you can see on Pyrogen, except from him, who's basically been the Terminator all day. He's angry. He's on skill. Everyone else maybe a bit more happy. But over on MYM, they're just... They must be feeling that they struggle so bad at the beginning. Something goes wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're just playing catch-up again. All the time.
I think, as we kind of talked about earlier on, that they don't really care about, you know, being in that kind of situation that they can always come back from. They've proved that they've been able to play catch-up, but it's got to be draining mentally on you to always be in that situation, to always be losing the beginning and have to catch up. Like, that has to take a toll on you.
Yeah, the adrenaline must be flowing every time, especially when the kills caught coming in like that. And that's what I think about Pyrogen. It's going so well for them right now.
Yeah.
They've got the flow.
They do have the flow. And right now, it looks like they will be on the U.S. side on Dawnbreaker. Meachmaker is going to be on the Chinese side. With that 25-second countdown remaining, you even hear Meachmaker's getting pumped up. Reminds me a lot of their League of Legends team, where they would get super pumped and hyped before every single match. And... Well, 10 seconds left to go on the countdown here. Let's see which team is going to pull us off. Will Pyrogen close us out in a 3-1 scoreline, or will Meachmaker pull it back to a 2-2 wall and take us into the final match? Remember, guys, this is the grand final. If you're just joining us, both teams playing for that first place, playing for the pride, playing for the glory. And let's see which team will pull it out here.
MYM have absolutely destroyed Epsilon on this map before. Can they have a repeat performance? Puncturl, first man down for MYM. He was making a push onto that B flag, but it seems that Woffy's pushed through to C. But this is pretty... Oh, that is bad. Straight away, Hexus goes down. The killing machine has been stopped. And this opens up for a ticket bleed straight away for MYM.
Yeah, looks like they will grab control of C and B. Looks like we'll be actually capped over as well. They are doing a fantastic job so far. Right now, Pyrogen seems to be at a loss of words. But then again, same thing happened on Zavod. And they finished that out with a 94-ticket lead. So it's not possible for them to come back from this one, obviously.
Yeah, even though there's a triple cap in effect here, look where everyone is on the map. It's still looking okay for Pyrogen.
It's looking really good. Because look at the line they've been able to build up, too. Like, they have people in the position are in the right positions around the map. Hexus, he's going to meet a 1-on-2. If he can pull this off, he will be a god. So I'm going to back away, play this one strategically, or will he run away completely away?
He's running because he was on low HP. He got murdered around the corner. He had to make a run for it. And you can see MYM circling around that A flag from all directions.
It's like watching Jaws. Dun, 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 dun. But he does go down, so that will be a cap. But in the meantime, Pyrogen immediately respond again with a cap on C. They are always a step ahead of Meachmakers, and if Meachmakers want to come back in this one, they need to start thinking harder. They need to start thinking further ahead. Now, Igaho looking for a couple of kills here. Let's get some suppression assists in there. A little bit of healing as well. They will be able to cap over B. And the ticket bleed, it's starting to go in favor of them. They have... Oh, no. They actually get Tain up for the backside. They aren't going to be able to lock that one down here just yet. And both teams only fighting with one flag right now.
And both these teams are spawning in very fast and heavy on top of each other. And that is what Pyro... both teams are doing it. So it's constant fights. Big fights. And whoever loses not only loses control of the flag, but more importantly, 4 or 5 tickets. And Pyrogen looks like they win big again in the center of the map. But they still have not gathered the control of the B flag yet.
And one man there being a nuisance picks up the kill, actually. It looks like we will have... Pyrogen locked down behind just a second, as well as A. They just went for a complete swap. But though, this is the thing that was funny to me. And this is the thing that, to me, that perfectly describes Pyrogen. Back when they were playing, I want to say it was Meachmakers, but it probably wasn't. On Parasol Storm, they did not give a care about the buildings. Right now, they do not care about the balcony. They are just rushing and getting B and then moving away. They're staying out of line of sight of that, and they're winning these fights one-on-one every time. 130 to 119 tickets, the bleed starting to come into full effect here as, again, Pyrogen just winning these duels out. And You see them grouping up. They're playing smart, and they're getting the kills at the same time. This is a really unstoppable team right now.
Yeah, they just got the momentum going right now, and they're circling this B flag quite a lot and threatening C. So MYM need to make sure that they dominate this B flag as quick as possible, or they're going to find a full domination cap against them. And that upper balcony might be helping, but right now,
I don't think it
is looking good.
That's the thing. I don't think it is. I think it's a detriment more than anything. They're committing, you know, two people up there, one or two every time. But look at this. It's a tri-cap coming in. It's, yeah, you get the positioning, but what do you really get from it if you're not picking up kills?
Yeah, safe in a awkward position here, knowing there's someone nearby, gets the kill, opens up a possibility of either B or A, and it looks like Pyro were expecting a push on A and left B wide open. They've jumped from the balcony, and now MYM are on the move once again, securing the B flag, but C is wide open, and I expect to spawn there very soon.
Yeah, I wouldn't be too surprised for that one, but we do have all five men of Paragon up. We're going to win out these duels here. Actually, we do have Funtrill getting the respawn, and does get taken down, though, and they will actually, I believe, do a one-for-one trade, but Safe going to get the revives. And right now, we see actually a big fight breaking out at B here. Malisium charging with the pistol, and will he get the kills? Oh, he's looking for the first one. He's going to get it. He's going to get the reload as well. He does stop the cap over. He gets a second one with the pistol. And it looks like that will be B contested a little bit longer. Picks up, actually switches his kit, picks up another gun, gets the kill. That's number three. He's actually dodging around the crates. He's looking for the fourth, but no, he doesn't get it. But either way, he stalled them for such a long time that now the rest of Pyro are going to push into this B flag, and they should be able to lock this one down.
Yeah, it's just Ducky Chan, and he goes down. And that is what happens when one man goes big, and it basically forces MYM off what should have been a flag of theirs. They had the kills, they had the men, they had the numbers. And it just didn't pan out. And now that line of defense is drawn in the sand. And look at Pyro. They're just all over and in the right places.
And even after all this amazing play, they've been able to pull off now Malisium 10 and 3. They don't have that big of a ticket lead. But this is the part of the game. This is the midsection of it where Mewtwo Makers just seem to fall to the wayside. And Pyrogen really kick things into the next gear. And right now, you can see Mewtwo Makers trying to fight back. Trying to really do something, but right now they're still being shut down. They aren't winning the duels, and if you can't win a one-on-one fight in an FPS game, you can't capture anything.
Yeah, and that's the issue here. They're constantly getting stuck. Now it seems like desperation for MYM. It's not like they're doing great, and that's why they're resorting to like grouping up like this. And that's fine for Pyrogen. They've got the bleed. Keep the fight as far away from that flag as possible, and they're doing a great job of it.
Yes, they are, and they are continuing this. Like, they are not giving up on the pressure. They are consistently putting this in their face. They are fighting for this tooth and nail, and it's really reflected right now because the score has finally opened up. The lead has finally become apparent. 98 to now 58 tickets, 40 ticket difference now. And if they keep this up, it's going to keep growing. And if I would imagine, honestly, if Pyrogen hit, let's just say, an 80 or more ticket lead in this map in the first half, I think that will be it. I think that's it.
Yeah, and right now it's really awkward because of a spawn that came in from Flashall right on top of the B flag. And more importantly, the one-on-one over at B did not go their way. And now the B and C hold is in effect, and the upper balcony might even switch over very soon to Pyro. And it does. This is not looking good for MYM.
This is not looking good at all. They need to kick into second gear or even sixth gear right now with a Ferrari because they are in such a tough position. They are going for the cap on a B here, but they are losing men left and right because of the positional advantage that Pyrogen does have. Malisium, I guess he was tired of us talking about Hexus and Monstro the entire time because now he's 15 and 5, and Hexus is only 14 and 7 right now. Let's see, he's going to be working around the backside, working in towards A here as they do have the swaps coming in. Looks like Pyrogen will cap the B as they do get the kills, but then again, there's still two people on Mage Maker's side contesting A here. They're fighting for it. Look, Malisium gets the kills. He gets one. He's looking for the second. He doesn't get it just yet, but gets SADF so low as he's forced to back out of this. And he gets it with the grenade, and that will be A taken for Pyrogen now.
Yeah, MYM need to consolidate onto this B flag and get it soon. Pull these people away from A and finish B, get it captured. But it doesn't look like they need my advice anyway, as they just push through anyway and try and get the kills. The spawns are going to come in on C, and there's not much you can do about it. So they need to consolidate and push that A flag. They are caught from all sides right now. Malisium at A, more importantly, Hexus over at C. Interesting though, Safe has spawned in as well, and this could get really interesting as he gets a kill at C, and they are starting to take tickets away from a team that was far, far ahead at one point.
Oh, Malisium that glass not being broken might have just saved his life. As the first bullet did hit, he instantly backed away. When you see two people on Power Regen's side get taken down, though, Melissa comes from the backside, gets the kill, and has maintained control here. In just a second, he gets the kill with the punch roll. He's waiting for him to peek up on top of those file cabs. He's going to jump straight in, but gets taken down from the side. And that will be a domination cap. Look at the spawns coming in for Power Regen. They need to make something happen quick here. And that two-man squad that's on Matchmaker's side up towards his balcony is actually starting to finally work out.
Yeah. Once again, MYM finding themselves far behind have started to make a comeback here, and this full domination cap is lasting far too long. And very soon in this matchup, MYM are going to take the lead for the first time in a while. How do they keep doing this? How have they got the nerves to keep this going? It's just incredible.
It was
incredible.
98 to like 50, and now it's 32 to 31.
Yeah, any MYM fans are definitely going to need a defib kit very soon.
This is getting dangerous to me as well, because when Matchmakers did this earlier on, they were able to get pumped up on Operation Locker. They came back 48 to 44 with that initial turnaround that they were finally able to apply towards the end of the first half. And right now, they've been able to take the lead, as you're saying before. B being contested right now, though. It looks like Pargen will be able to capitalize off of that one. Safe, though. Looking for another man. He's going to spot out Malisium right there, but not going to go head-to-head against him. Not going to fight that one out. I'm just going to back away from those grenades that have been flooding into his hallway here. But B hasn't been taken just yet here. Matchmaker's going for the push-in. They do get taken down. And it looks like this will finally be going over in Powergen's favor. So they're going to get the two-cap hold. They might be able to pull off a lead out of this half, but that is not the lead that they had earlier on.
No, not at all. Spawns for MYM are far away from any flag, and they probably have one good push left on that B flag. It's all about B, and Monstro and Hexus, two of the big names and killers, are the ones defending that flag, and be worried that a spawn from Pyro could come on that C flag at any time. MYM need to move quick, and they need to get the kills, and there is that spawn, and it's MYM that get it on C. MYM need to push quickly. 11, 10 for 20, and right now, whoever gets the next bleeding halt is going to win.
There you go. Gets one kill on a Fox right there. He's trying to stop this cap on A here. He's actually successfully done it. Going to get some positional advantage, though, backing away. And she sees one man in there. Puncho picks up the kill with 5 tickets remaining. It looks like that's just going to be it here. If they can't neutralize it, as Malisium comes in, picks up a big kill, that will be it here for the first half. 17-2 looks like it will be the score line, or 17-1 now, but 17 tickets, considering how big of a lead that Power Regen had, that is nothing. It is nothing.
Nothing at all. More importantly, MYM were playing on the harder faction in that matchup, and that might be the deciding factor on this map. Malisium, massive scores there, a lot to do with his position in the game. Monstro is possibly the most important player they have. Now, Hexus might be getting the kills and Malisium might be getting the frags there, but Monstro is doing things which are keeping the flags, and that is keeping Pyro on course for the first EMS champion.
Yes, very, very true. And we're going to see if that's going to continue here as we get to the second half in just a few. But right now, they are one half away from winning. One half, that's all it takes.
This is going to be close, I think. But then, this has happened before, and MYM just come out the next time and just smash. Yeah. So we'll have to wait and see. They are going to get... They should get the B flag straight away. They should get the bleed right off the back. If they don't, Pyro Regen will take this map.
All right, well, you heard it here, folks. Let's see if that's going to happen here, as now we're loading back in. That second half will be kicking off. Can Matchmakers come back from this one? Can they take it to a map number 5, which would be on Siege of Shanghai? Well, Power Regen placing pretty much dead last in terms of the points of who gets into the groups to have that Cinderella story, get the slipper on their foot, and get into and win now the grand finals. That would be huge for them, honestly. I would imagine they would go crazy, as we've already heard them super pumped after winning, with 80 points, ahead, but a victory in the grand finals against Matchmakers, the dark horse.
You're never going to let that one go. No. You're obsessed with the dark horse.
I don't understand it. I just, even till this day, I just will never understand it.
I'll get you a Wikipedia entry on it. Maybe that'll help you.
Yeah, it actually might. All right, here you go. Countdown is now over. As you catch me in the tail end of spinning the camera around, and we will have the spawn push coming out of Power Regen. And here it comes. This is the big spot you're talking about. This is the big point of contention. Which team will pull off this fight? And we do see no kills come in just yet. Power Regen throwing their grenades in. They actually see where they are, as we do see the first death come in. It's going to be in Matchmaker's favor. And it looks like they have given this one up here. They're not going to get the B take. We actually do see on the, around the backside, one man on Magemaker's trying to go for the flank. But so far, Magemaker's getting a good, strong start here.
Yeah, initial bleed coming in for MYM. That's good for them. They must know that C is probably going to be at some point attacked. And Flax is close enough to defend it, but he needs to do it quickly here as Aikaho trying to get that capture. He gets taken down. That bleed is continuing. But right now, they've got to be worried about B. Any feint on C is really just to keep the attack on to B going. And there you go. Flash Orb getting the kill on that flag. And MYM need to do something quick because that bleed is straight over to Pyrogen.
Yes, it is. And obviously, 17 tickets is not that much in the end. But it's going to come down to the wire here, I want to imagine, between these two teams. Waffly trying to hold on to this balcony side as he actually takes down. Magemaker's lose two people to the hands of Hexus. He's going to chase down that third, potentially fourth right now, even potentially fifth as he's looking for the kills. He gets taken down by Punch Roll. And in the meantime, though, it allows Flashard, who picks up two kills for himself, to push straight into C here. We're going to see a tri-cap.
Yeah, that's if Flash Orton catches quickly. He is incoming, gets one kill. Spawns are coming on top of him. That's important, and that is the first tri-cap. And Flash Orton doing brilliant work there. Eventually, probably going to be overwhelmed. Hexus goes down, and it will be MYM taking back the C flag. But right now, B is something. MYM need to attack everywhere, and that's what they're doing. But look at the response straight away. Flash Orb and Malicium are already going to A. This is looking really good for them, especially when Safe gets taken down by Monstro. Once again, a key player for Pyrogen, and a one that's causing no end of trouble to MYM.
And well, B, though, will be neutralized. Flasher will be nading in, trying to stop this cap from happening. Of course, for him, those nades won't really connect. And B now back over to the control of Magemaker. So that nade coming in perfectly well placed. Picks up a kill, looking for a second. And he's spraying up towards that balcony side as well. He's not going to get it just here. Ikaho looking for a third man. And he's trying to neutralize it here, but he has men on all different sides of him. He's just going to spray and pray down one more guy here. And the rest of the Pyrogen have pushed up. They have that solid line. And now this could be big. Monstro, you talked about him before. Can he get any kills right here? He's looking for the one man on Waffy. He's not hitting the shots, unfortunately. He's going to spot on the corner. He sees Punch Roll, switches the pistol, but he gets taken down. And B now being contested, but that should go still in Pyrogen's favor here.
Yeah, and Pyrogen just spawning more and more people onto the B flag, and it's a fight that keeps dragging on. And it's a wonder MYM are not winning constantly. Once again, MYM get wiped out at B, and that is a fight that just broke out at C. Wow!
Hex is picking up the kill. He actually is going to contest this one as well. He's going to force someone back on Magemaker. You see two spawns come in. Hex is, can he hold on to this in a 1v2? No, he can't. He's going to get taken down. But now, Punch Rule on the balcony side with the respawning on top of him. They have a positional advantage right now as we do see Flasher running straight over towards the other side of the street, trying to take down the man that's coming. It's destroyed right there. And now A's vulnerable. The backside of Elysium's vulnerable if he doesn't turn around here in just a second. And this is going to be very dangerous. He does finally fall. And now Pyrogen pretty much almost getting completely wiped out. They need to do something here. Monster looking to be that monster that he truly is. He needs to make something happen here soon. 112 to 83 tickets, and Pyrogen have lost that 2-cap here. However, they should be able to maintain it with the help of Flasher on the back of C.
Yeah, and Pyrogen are just in better positions here to deal with MYM, and they're getting the kills to prove it. And right now, A and B might go to MYM, but reinforcements for Pyrogen, massive spawns on to the B flag, and this is going to be painful. MYM need to do something quickly here, because they are losing control of the most important flag on the map.
And we're approaching 40 tickets on top of that difference between these two teams. And B will be locked down here, and Flasher, can he come out winning out this fight right here? Can he stall them? As he's actually, one thing I love about Pyrogen though is everyone can play every role. You don't have that one person that always plays anchor. You don't have that one man that's always a slayer, even though, you know, Hexus and obviously Munch have been proving that a little bit wrong, but everyone can do everything. And everyone reacts so quickly to each other's calls that, you know, if one person realizes, hey, we have three people at B already, I already know where they're looking, I can go in a different direction and hold that angle down. And they are adapting so quickly to Magemaker. They're trying to play their own game here. Right now, they have been two capped, and they need to pull something back here in just a second. And it looks like it might come down to A here if Hexus can pick up this kill.
Yeah, Punchal can do a bit of a delaying action, but he seems to want to go back to B, and that's understandable here. But right now, this is the thing about Pyrogen. Sometimes the train just gets derailed, and then wrong kills come in everywhere and flag captures. This happened against Dignitas, and it did happen against MYM earlier today. And if there's one map that MYM do quite well on from behind, it is this one. And once again, this game is starting to even up.
It definitely is. And so there's only a 17 ticket threshold for Magemaker right now. They have to make sure everything counts. Let's check out that they are able to apply. It's worked out well for them. They actually get a kill from Flax on the backside onto Monstro, stops the push on a C here. And not to mention, Puncher actually capped A, so they almost have a tri-cap right now. And Pyrogen, just like you're saying, being derailed, they don't even know where they're going. They need to make something happen soon. They need to make a decisive decision, or that lead that they built up with almost 40 tickets is, well, it's going to be gone. It already is now.
Trip cap. That is a trip cap by MYM on to Pyrogen. Once again, Pyrogen looking strong at first, and then all of it just goes wrong. And I honestly cannot tell you why. They are been looking so strong, then all of a sudden it just comes apart. But there you go. Even though that there's a full cap against them, they have a chance to take B, hold C, and it's a one-on-one that's going to decide this safe versus Hexus.
Safe, not going to get the kill, but he does get some spawns on top of the gate. It's going to come out, but Hex is going to run the backside. In the meantime, Meachmaker is going to rush straight into C. They're going to go for the cap here, but let's take... Well, actually, Flax picked up the kill onto Hexus in the back, so they will get control of C here, but Igaho, if he can come out big, if he can get this one kill that he needs to his right side, which is not even looking, which he won't get, he could have maintained control of A, and now Meachmaker is able to get a tri-cap yet again here. Pyrogen, what is happening? They are losing on this map. They have 56 tickets left. This is going to be exactly what we saw in Operation Locker, I feel.
Yeah, and more importantly, this is a complete control by MYM. They are doing the impossible yet again. Fighting a retreat has become a possible victory for them. This is absolutely top level. Pyro just look amazing some rounds, and then it kind of collapses the next. I don't know what to say. Ducky-chan taking out two, threatening A now. This is Pyrogen on the back foot for the first time in a long time, and C is going up a 2-on-1, and Monstro needs reinforcements, or he just needs to kill both guys.
Yes, he does, and this is the time for him to prove how much of a monster he is. He does get the respawn, though. Hex is jumping in the backside. He's still alive here, fighting for his life, fighting for the flag. He takes that punch rule. It's going to be neutralized, but then again, Meachmaker's committing two more people to that. They're going to lock that down here, and we're seeing Flax trying to hold on to, or trying to actually capture A over. Pyrogen finally got that 2 kept back, but he gets eliminated. Now we need to see Pyrogen send everyone they possibly can over towards B to hold on to this push that Meachmaker is throwing at him, because we are getting so damn close to this map being over almost in any team's favor at this point.
Yeah, but this might favor Pyrogen more than any. They just need to rush in and hold this B flag as quick as possible. But the thing is, MYM know what they need to do, but the kills are coming for Pyro, but Hexus is the only guy left forward, and he gets taken out. This has forced Monstro back, but the capture at C is coming down.
William's pulling three people. He's pulling all three people back, so if he can pick up these three kills, that's almost going to be it. He picks up one. He gets the almost gets the cap onto it. It's just just a sliver of life left. He does get taken down, but he pulled so many people back that now Pyrogen are going to cap B here, but look at this. Safe. Look where he is. He is on A. He's getting respawns. They're going to get control of A and C. They're getting the 2 cap back here. And Pyrogen, again, they have to fight up against this hill. They have to get something back right now. And they're getting so close to being tied up here 2-2 in maps.
Yeah, and MYM just need to play a solid game here. Not get too crazy. They must know that A is under attack by a lot of people, but they must know at the same time, any man who goes to B now is going to be pretty much killed.
Oh, Hexus! He's a Luffy, he gets Waffy, he gets the kill. That's going to be C locked down. There's no one else near them. They're going to get a tri-cap here. They're going to get so many tickets off this. Milisim can pick up a couple of kills. He's going to lock things down. He gets one. He's almost here in the second, but he gets shut down. And that would be A traded for C here.
Yeah, it all comes down to B. Once again, the most important flag on this map. And MYM can go for it or rush for C. And Puntrul is doing just that. The rest of MYM need to play smart here. Think about what they're doing and not get too crazy. They have time on the board. This is not done for either team just yet. But they need to play smart. Right now, Flax needs to back off. Hold that A flag. He's the only man that can do it. And they all get taken out.
They get the two kills. They're going to get control of A. Now they need to rush everyone back towards B. They're every man they possibly have. 11, 10 tickets remaining for them. They need to get this cap. It will come in just a second, but more importantly, they have to hold on to this B, which is currently being capped over for Meachmakers. It's going to be neutralized now. 8 tickets remain. They need to bleed away 10 more for Meachmakers to lock down their victory and secure themselves as the winners of the first season of the MS1 Battlefield 4 series. And right now, Meachmakers are fighting tooth and nail.
It's all about getting in that cap zone. Pyrogen to win. The EMS need to just get into that flag zone. They're not doing it. There's only one left. It's Monstro. But if he can't get in that zone, they will not get the capture. Yeah! And there you go. We're going to another map.
Wow. Woo! Meachmakers.
How do they do this? How can you put yourself in a position where you're that far behind and still manage to win the map?
I think one thing that helped was Puntrul going 23-9.
Yeah, yeah, that helps. But
oh man,
like you're saying with Pyro, Ikaho's are great, Monstro's great, Hexa's great, Flash was great, Melisium great. None of them are above the other. They all chip in and do a great job. MYM, the same, but Puntral always gets kills like that. In a series, it will happen, and it pushes them to win maps.
You know what that means, right? We're going to Siege of Shanghai. The final map now. The final map guaranteed of this season, of this tournament. You're worried about this map. This is a map that can go either way. You don't feel too heavily one-sided for either team right now.
Yeah, but I'm going to say something which cursed Epsilon and lost them heavily.
Okay.
I think Pyrogen on Siege can do it. I feel that they just have this chemistry that works as soon as the kills start coming, and it just goes out of control. But MYM seem to derail that train every so often, and when they do, they just take control of the game so dominantly.
Yes, they do. They are so good at throwing in whatever derails trains.
A train stopper, I know who they are.
That works. But in the meantime, trains. Before we get into the final map of the match in this best of five of the grand finals, we're going to head over to Red Eye and Benson one more time to discuss those last two maps.
Thanks very much, champs. Ben, deep breath. Fifth map incoming, but let's just wrap up the last two. It almost seems like a mirror image of the first two maps. In the third map, Pyro, back to their best again, back to where they were doing things really well in map one, got it all locked down, take a 2-1 lead, all looks healthy for them. Map four, they have a reasonable lead from the first half. In fact, there were 50 tickets at one point, and MYM locked them down to 17 in the end. So really great comeback from MYM to really restrict them to 17, but still it looked like a tall order to come back and win and turn around. And there it is, it happens again. The comeback kings are still in the game, it's 2-2. Interestingly as well, let's just consider this for a moment. Pyro were 9 tickets away from Championship Glory.
I knew you were going to bring that up.
Yeah, it's so close, it's within touching distance, but now they have to reset and do it all again. Mindsets now, Ben. Pyro disappointed after that, obviously. They're going to be like, ah, damn it, 9 tickets and we would have won this thing, and now we have to do another map. MYM, on the other hand, wind in their sails, confidence flowing again. They've gotten rid of the first and third map, but is it odd one out each time? Is it first, third, and fifth for them that they struggle on?
It could well be that case, but what I've been really impressed with by Pyro is after every single map, win or lose, you know, they'll get themselves into that group huddle, they'll discuss, all right, what went right, what went wrong, how can we improve? That mentality is only going to benefit you in the long run.
It's interesting, isn't it? Because you're right to point that out. All of MYM have got up, they've gone outside, they've gone to get some fresh air, they've got to do whatever they need to chill out. Pyro are still sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
They're all grouped round. They're all talking to each other. They're discussing what they're going to do for the last map. You're
right. Exactly. Not in a negative way, though.
No,
that's the key.
Absolutely not. No, they didn't look downhearted or anything. They look like they're ready. And they've just been given the one-minute signal. So they'll be popping back to their chairs momentarily. MYM are just sauntering back in as well. It's been a terrific weekend. I can't think of a better way than to top the final off with a five-mapper.
We've been blessed.
We really have been very lucky.
It's the perfect send-off, it really is, for a fantastic tournament. I just had a feeling it was going to end this way, though. I just really had a feeling it was going to go all the way to that fifth map. Both these two teams look so good all weekend, but you know, if I'm sat at home watching this, I'm thinking, well, when Pyro have won, they've done it a little bit more emphatically. It hasn't been tough.
Yes, you're absolutely right. It's a very good point. Maps 1 and 3, they were...
so simple for them.
Yeah, they were dominant on maps 1 and 3. There was no doubt about it. Maps 2 and 4, though, probably should have wrapped up at some point and ended up not winning it, mainly through MYM's resilience more than anything else.
Yeah, pretty much. They just don't want to lose. They're here to win, and it showed through. But going into that fifth map now, I kind of don't want to put bad wuju on them, but...
And let's not do that. Let's not make any predictions right now, because the predictions are locked in, and you guys can't change your predictions anymore anyway. It's going to be a fantastic last map. And I honestly think now we could probably take a coin out of our pocket and flip it for either one of these to win, because it's going to come down to little details now. It's going to come down to a moment of madness or a mistake or a moment of brilliance from one of these players.
Absolutely.
And that can change the whole game around and win the match for them, win the championship for them.
Yeah, definitely. I'm looking at, you know, some of the top players from both these two teams now to really come out, and you have to forget about the whole tournament. It doesn't matter now. It's this one game. It's going to decide everything.
It's not single elimination. It's single map. Single exactly map that. Takes all. Winner Pretty takes much. All on a single map. So it's not quite all, of course, because second place does get 5,000 euros, but it's first place, 10,000, plus the gold medals, plus the trophy. There's a lot on the line for this last map. Before we go back to the commentators, players are almost ready. Let's talk nerves as well right now. Are they going to creep in for this fifth map? I mean, they crept in at the start. I think you could see it, but now they're settled, right?
Because of the break, I think you are going to see maybe a little bit of nerves in the first 60 seconds or so. But as soon as that's gone, they're going to be like, oh, yeah, back to where we were, you know, a couple of minutes ago. Game time. Let's play.
Okay. Thank you very much, Ben. It's been a pleasure having you here. Let's go back to our commentary team for the fifth and final map. Gents, I know you're going to enjoy this, and I hope you at home are going to enjoy it as well. We're about to crown our first ever EMS1 champion for Battlefield 4.
All right, thank you very much. I'm still kind of speechless. Actually, I went to the restroom, and actually I ran to Ikaho, and I ran to one man, I don't know his name off the top of my head, from Meet Your Makers, and they were talking. I think it was Safe, actually. And they were like, wow, this is like the best final ever. This is one of the closest like games we've ever seen, and we're going into Siege of Shanghai next. A map that they both actually don't want to play on right now. They wish they could switch up last second, but it's a map that both teams don't like equally, which pretty much tells you that you don't know who's going to win it at that point.
It's the wildcard map. It really is.
Yeah.
It's going to be one of these maps which is just going to be hard to call. But I got a feeling. Here's my feeling on how this map's going to go. One team is going to just storm it.
I thought you were going to say one team will win. I'm like, wow, what a feeling.
Yeah, one team is going to win this.
And will there be one loser?
There will be no losers.
All right, well, we will get this underway shortly. We're just having the map load up yet again here. And both teams, I think I saw Safe's hand shaking a little bit. He was like, I don't know if there's a Red Bull, though, but he was really like, he wasn't freaking out, but he was super excited over how close this game's been. And right now, we're getting underway here in just a few with this final map, Siege of Shanghai. We're going to have Meet Your Makers over on the Chinese side, Pyrogen over on the U.S. And you said, we think one team is going to win this one easily. If the trend continues, we had, obviously, Pyrogen went on the first map, 80 tickets.
Mm-hmm.
On the second map, we had a very close game, 44-48, where Meet Your Makers won. Third map on Zavod, 94 tickets for Pyrogen. The last map on Dawnbreaker, 17-26, very close on tickets. The trend continues. It's going to be a very one-sided game, like you're saying.
Yeah, I feel like that. And I think it depends on the break here. B is going to be a very, very important flag. Both teams should probably go for it. But then, in response, Pyro might try and sneak around that A flag. The A-B hold is what Meet Your Makers will start with. And they have the better start, better spawn by far. And they have sent two to B, and they might get overrun.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, we are into the final map. Out of this entire event right now, we're into the grand finals, map number 5. You guys have voted who you think was going to win. Let's see if you guys are going to be right or wrong here. And Pyrogen off to a strong start. Looks like they will be able to thwart that entire attack onto B. Gain control of C and B, get that early 2-1 hold. But Ducky-chan trying to be sneaky, but he's not Sneaky-chan, he's Ducky, as he does get taken down. And we're going to see Pyrogen go for a cap onto B and A now. They're going to swap it up here, and Monstro, if he could pick up these two kills, this is going to be huge. He's looking for the first one on Flax. He's not going to take it, though. Flax is going to turn it onto his head and pick up that one. So C will be capped over in the end. But Malician is playing a little bit of a floater role. He's looking for anyone they could possibly kill. And you can see the push onto A is being shut down a little bit here. Now we're going to tag in along with Hexus. Can he stop this push coming in from the shop? And instead, he's just going to nade it up. Going to actually buy him a lot of time to heal, too. Why do you chase him down? No, he's going to just push him away. And we're seeing an attack come in at B here.
Yeah, and flags all over the map are being attacked, A and B, one-on-one over A, and it looks like Puncher decided to give up that fight at A, going the long way round. But at the same time, the fight at B is still continuing. This is just a back-and-forth game straight away.
Very back-and-forth, and I'm agree with you. I'm in the same boat when it comes down to, in the end, there's going to be one clear victor in this one. And
that's huge. That's huge. Puncher 2-on-1 breaks through to that A flag, and there's a possibility of a full domination cap in effect here. MYM breaking through the line, and they're making a fight at it at C as well.
Yes, they are. And Hexus looks like he's going to be able to cap this one over since they all went for pretty much the respawn there. We do have, though, Monstro pushing in towards B. Let's hang along with him. Let's see if he can pick up these two kills that he's going to need. He just spot one man out, but right in the corner, he gets taken down here. And finally, it looks like Meet Your Makers have been able to draw their line in the sand and start to build up a little bit of advantage here. Having A, having B, getting kills left and right, currently 18-11. It's looking good if you're a Meet Your Makers fan.
Yeah, and this is what I talk about Pyro. They look good for so long, and then all of a sudden these kills kind of come like a waterfall, and it's all over the place, and they struggle. And I don't get it. They do so well, and then it just goes so wrong. But right now, even that being said, they are only a bit behind here, and a fresh attack on B might rescue them. And a spawn round A is probably inevitable at this point.
Yeah, I think you're definitely right here, as we do see Argent going to be pushing in back to B yet again, looking for some sort of play on B. As you see, Flasher, he's trying to stay alive, 29 health, he's staying healthy enough, but looks like they will be able to cap B over, though. In the meantime, is he safe? He's actually going for a counter cap, and he's going to be sitting inside a steel container, looking for someone to push into him. He's getting the respawns as well. They're going to push out here in just a second, I want to imagine, but they get naded in their face. They're backing away now, and I think, I want to say Flasher can hold on to this 1v2 if he gets the kills that he needs.
Yeah, he needs to. There was a push at A, but it got shut down by Ducky, and that B fight goes decisively for MYM. At the meantime, C is wide open for an attack, but once again, this game is looking really bad for Pyro. That B flag is constantly with MYM.
It is, and Pyrogen, they seem to just give it up. They don't really care about it. They're going for A and C. They just want to grab any flag that they possibly can, and they're going to send two men over towards B right now, but they're up against a three-man squad. I'm not sure if they can penetrate these defenses, because right now, 113 to 87 tickets, Mutual Makers have finally been able to build up a lead that they've been struggling to do in quite a few of the maps currently.
Yeah, and they're just constantly... So there's a one-on-one left. Hexus against Ducky-chan. No spawns in yet, and it goes Ducky-chan's way. That is... And at the same time, A is being threatened by Safe, and while this is going on, Flax is holding C. A full domination cap could happen here, and Pyro are scrambling to stop this A capture.
Yes, they are, and Monstro, it looks like he will be able to cap C back for himself here, but it might just be a little bit too late. They've already fallen 30 tickets behind, plus almost 40 at this point, and we can hear Meech Makers over on their comms right now, and
Wireflex.
These are really damn calm, considering what's at stake here. Calls are short, they're precise, and everyone knows what they're doing.
Four randoms they just called for. No spawning on players. All go random and see where you spawn. And all of those have been up near C. A single man push at B shut down from Pyro. But that random spawn that they called for, you heard it, was going to give them a possible spawn on A or C, and they got it at C instead.
All right, well, now they're fighting C. There's going to be a three-man push. See Milicium trying to hold on to this. He does pick up one kill. Look at the second. We'll get taken down, though, and that will be C capped over for Mitch Makers. But immediately, you see Flasher. You see Ika rushing straight towards B here. They get the respawns. Can Flasher lead the charge into B, or is he going to go over towards C right now? He sees Swaffy. Actually turns the kill back onto him. And right now, this is getting very dangerous right now for Power Gym. 57 takes to 95. They are falling by the wayside. They need to do something here, and they just seem to be lost words. They just are dying left and right.
Welcome to Siege of Shanghai, the map that's replaced Dawnbreaker as the one where massive scores can come into effect quickly. But don't be disheartened, Pyrogen fans. Remember that MYM were able to come back from this, so why not Pyrogen? And this is still looking good for MYM, but not too far away from being salvaged by Pyrogen. They just need to get the right kills and get the flag caps.
They do, and right now, Meech Makers, 50 kills to 31. They are doing everything they possibly can to not allow those kills to come into play. And we're seeing a push, a four-man push, actually, by Pyrogen onto this A flag, and they're getting shut down quite well. They're getting the revives in, but there's two men of Meech Makers here. Will they pick up the kills, or will they get shut down? Safe gets taken down. There's going to be one man in the shop. Flax. When they get flanked around, he picks up one, he picks up number two. It looks like, actually, the backup comes in for Meech Makers, and they stop the push on A. They have pretty much just destroyed Pyrogen, and now they're down to 29 tickets here.
Pyrogen will spawn everyone on B right now. They have to break it, and they have to break it soon. But while this happens, more and more MYM are filtering into that flag, but it's just Ducky-chan left. It's him by himself holding the B flag, and I don't even know if Pyrogen knows he's there. They eventually discover his presence and kill him, and this is the chance that Pyrogen need to come back in this game, because 23 to 88 right now, not looking great, but a full domination cap is how they're going to try and respond.
And they might be able to pull it off too. They're going for the cap on A. They're going to pull the one off here, but will they lose out on C as Meech Makers have gone for the respawns on top of it? Safe gets taken down. And we do see the return kill back onto the man that was by the boxes straight in front of you. And C, well, they haven't capped it over just yet. They're taking their damn time. Why are they doing this? As they do finally get someone on top of it, but it took a long time, maybe too long. But right now, 21 to 72 is the ticket difference between these two teams. And Pyrogen, they're fighting. They are fighting as hard as they can, but is it too late?
It's not too late. They are in a great position here, but it all comes down to B. They need to hold this flag. It's just Hexus by himself. More spawning. Welcome to domination, people. Oh, no, that's what happens, and that's the pain you can get if you spawn your teammates on top of you. They get killed because they have no idea where the enemy are.
They do not, and we're going to see C trade over, but as well as A going for the side of Mutual Makers, and 66-16. This is looking to be the biggest lead that Mutual Makers will have coming into a second half, or actually the first time they'll ever have a lead against PyroGen coming into the second half. And with that big of one, you kind of called it. You're saying there's going to be pretty much a landslide for one of these teams, and right now Mutual Makers, they're stepping up to the plate.
Yeah, but PyroGen are getting important kills. They broke through to A, and they're going to be able to get that capture. Milesium versus Flax and Pontrol at B. While this is going on, C is going to swing over decisively, and this is the last gasp on this round for PyroGen. They need to overwhelm this B flag, and they need to do it now. They have no other time. They need to get into that flag, and Pontrol is shutting them down one at a time. And Monstro goes down, and so does the last hope of salvaging this round.
All right, so we're looking at 60 tickets now in favor of Mutual Makers. End of the first half. First time they've ever had a lead here in this best of five, and we're going to go into the second half where PyroGen, they are not out just yet. As you were saying before, Siege of Shanghai become the new Dawnbreaker. It's not possible to get these giant leads, and it's not possible to come back from the 60-point deficit.
Well, we've seen teams come back from some crazy stuff today.
Yes,
I would not be surprised to see PyroGen doing it. And you can just see everyone is looking calm over in the NYM camp. Over in PyroGen, they just look like they were almost getting ready to start. But they must be getting worried right now.
They have to be. I mean, they've already fought this hard. I mean, obviously they can be happy with how far they've gotten right now, but no one ever wants second. No one ever wants to be that first runner-up. They want to have the glory, they want to have the fame, and not to mention the money of winning this one out. And obviously we'll be kicking off the second half shortly here, but Mutual Makers, 60 tickets to work with. And I want to stress this again, first time they've had a lead come into the second half in this best of five. First time.
And we've always talked about MYM. Why do they always end up having to play from behind and then doing so well?
Yeah.
Maybe what are they going to do now that they have a lead?
Well, hopefully it's not the opposite. Hopefully they don't start off strong and then completely fall behind. And obviously they have 90 tickets to work with here that they can play with.
Well, if you want some the brighter side of this for the PyroGen team, they will be starting with the more likely better spawn. A and B should go their way.
Thing to me is, though, it wasn't the spawn that won that round for Mutual Makers. It was Pontrol and everyone else stepping up their aim when they really needed to.
Yeah, and it was in the right position at the right time, and they just did a great job. This is going to come down to the middle fight. B, and if MYM want to play that game, they have got more room to work with. Maybe they want this game to go into flux and just make it chaos and keep it close.
All right, well, countdown has begun. We're down to 5 seconds remaining. We're going to see PyroGen over on the Chinese side and Mutual Makers over on the U.S. And we're going to find out who your victor is going to be at the end of this half, ladies and gentlemen. We are at the tail end of this entire season. And let's see how this one goes. A, going to be captured for PyroGen. B, going to be taken with three people. But can Mutual Makers fight back here? Can they get the kills they need? And we'll see B get locked down for PyroGen. So now the 2-1 hold in favor of them. Remember, they're fighting on quite a few tickets, and they have no one at A currently.
Two went down, and Waffy and Pontrol doing the damage. And more importantly, one man left from PyroGen at B, but it's Flash or respawns came in. But there's the initial bleed, and it all comes down to B. All of this movement is really just to try and keep this flag open to an attack, and it's probably going to come in very, very soon.
Now we're going to find out if PyroGen can recover from this one. They've been having a tough time doing it this pretty much best of five. B isn't being capped over just yet, but we are hearing PyroGen currently now in their cars. What do you take from this so far, from just what you're hearing?
Well, unfortunately, I don't know.
Okay, well, that right there kind of tells it to me that they're feeling the pressure. They are 100% feeling the pressure.
Especially on B, because right now that's where it's all coming down. And you can see the spawns coming in, everyone spawning in, and PyroGen having the better time of it because of their spread. They've got a semicircle around MYM there, and they're getting the kills. This game is pretty close right now with MYM being forced onto the C flag. They went for a randomized spawn, and they got it far, far away at C. And this is PyroGen's chance to win.
And Flasher, He's going to go down here in just a second. He has to be going down. Yep, there it is. We have one man safe pushing from the side. But then again, look at Ikaho. He's waiting for this man to round the corner. If he hits his kill, it's going to be huge. He's going to belt control. Hey, he's going to get the first shots off. But look at them. No! Save picks it up. And that alone might have given control. Yes, even with the kill coming in for Ducky Chan, they're going to get control of A here. This is going to be a 2-1 hold as we do have the spawn for Foster, though, coming around the backside.
They're all down. B is open. The door to the championship just opened. As soon as B goes down, that is the most important flag. And MYM took it by feigning attack A, which they took and won anyway, but then taking it at B. Across the board, the smaller attack and the big attack all pay off, but they haven't been in the right position to defend B, and Ikaho sneaks in a capture and two kills. And when it looked great, it just went sour.
Did, and right now we're seeing actually Power Jam pick up quite a few kills. They almost completely wipe out Mutual Makers, as we do have one man over towards the top side, Hexus, and basically a 1-on-3 right now. If he could pull this off, it would be exactly what Power Jam needed. It would be that boost. They have control of B, they have control of C. Can he maintain control? He's picking up one, he picks up a second, and there's going to be one man behind him. Will he actually pick up a third as well, as he's right above him on this escalator? He's going to turn around, he's going to charge him straight into his face. Will he get the kill as he needs? Yes, he will! That's going to be three kills. That's going to be a hold onto C. He's going to get the revive on top of that. Or no, he's actually going to bypass him. He says, screw you, teammate. I need to pick up more kills. He's getting a fourth now, looking for potentially more. Remember, and Hexus went big against Fnatic on Zavod earlier on in that semifinal. It carried them through the game, and right now, he is a single man wrecking ball.
That's because they're playing up against the wall right now. 60 tickets is the cutoff point right now. They are ahead in this round, and they're threatening a full domination cap, and MYM are stuck in the top left side of this map and nowhere near any flag except from C, and that is not good. But look at Pontrol sneaking around A.
And he is, well, he's not going to be spotted right now. We do have one man there, but Hexus gets taken down. So looks like they will control A, they will control C yet again here, but Power Jam, they need to respond quick. Ikaho going to go head-to-head up against one man, gets a kill on the Waffy. That will actually get C back if he wants to go take it here. And A being contested, Flashler is going to give his chance. He's going to give all he can to stop this cap on A, maybe turn around. He's going to come in from the backside. He's going to have that 100 health. But will he get the shots up? He spots out Puntro, gets the kill onto him. He has 3 HP left. He's going to continue to push in. He will get taken out from the side, though, but he has a teammate spawning in. And we still see Meteor Makers is winning this fight in the hands of Flax, but he finally falls. That will be A traded back as we had Ikaho finally go for the cap on a C. Power Jam, they're not out just yet. It's 106 to 82 tickets, and they're getting closer to potentially locking this one down and holding on.
Well, we're not going to get a boring final here. Both these teams are just going right for it. MYM are behind right now, but they are threatening the flag capture. But once again, can they hold B? They had great success in the previous round, but in this one, it's not been there, and Power Jam are on the march for that B.
And those nades are just flooding in right into Waffy's face. He's able to dodge out quite a few of them, able to heal up. They do get one kill, but then you see the rest of Harjan moving from the side. We're going to see about a 3-on-3 fight, but look at the position Waffy's in. He's right behind them. Is he going to push out and spot them out, or no? Is he actually just going to mark them for his teammates? He's actually going to push out right into Mantra. Will he get the kill? He does pick that one up and has stopped that push onto B. Here's going to be one more man. He gets the kill onto him. He's going to actually get taken out from the backside finally, but he has made his presence known, and they're going to get the cap on A. They're going to lose C, though, and not to mention, they are able to hold on to B with the help of him, but Hexus, actually no, sorry, they do cap B over for Power Jam, but it's getting so close. 64 tickets remaining for Meteor Makers, 96 for Power Jam.
And do you know what's going to happen here? You know what's going to happen here? MYM are just going to stick on C and A. That's what they want. They just need the ticket bleed. They don't need nothing more. They are going to hold this C and A and bleed those tickets out of Pyrogen. And as soon as Pyrogen send too many people, they will overwhelm a weakly defended B.
They've been able to do that so far. It looks like they're going to do that right now. They get control of B. We see three men on the side of Pyrogen being stopped by one man or two men. As Waffy does get taken down, they're going to get control of A here. Not to mention Flash, who's already in prime position for C. We see three men on Meteor Makers heading straight for him. Can he defend against this? He's gonna have two from his right. He's gonna have one in front of him. He actually spots out Pruntrul. Nade coming in as we do get a respawn on top of him. He gets taken down, but he has stalled long enough that maybe now Pyrogen can go for this hit on a B.
This game is just going crazy right now. Ducky-chan, sole defender for B, one-on-one with the great one as Wolfie comes in from behind and finishes it off. Can't believe I got a wrestling reference in here. And more importantly, MYM are closing this one out. There's not many tickets left in this game at all.
There's 19 to go here, but they only have 53 remaining. If we do see Power Jam get that two-man hold that they need, that two-cap, they might be able to make things happen. They do get control of C. They do have control of A currently, but that will get swapped over in just a second as Ducky-chan defending onto B. And you can hear Meteor Makers, they are pumped up. They realize we are so damn close from locking this one away. We just need a couple more kills. Another two cap will make sure to secure this. And Meteor Makers getting threatened at B now.
Yeah, and MYM again, overrun at that B flag. It's a two four-man push on two, and you can see straight away MYM's attention is straight onto that C flag, and they're running for it right
but
now.
But look at this! Power Generator position to stop this. They have three men there to the two of Meteor Makers, and Ikaho is going to get taken down, but he will get the assist. They will wipe out that squad that is there, and now we see the backhand coming out of Flasher. We get a kill from Monster on taken down in the end, and can Flasher hold on to A? He's going to get finally fall, and that will be a cat back over for Meteor Makers, but the two cap hold is still in favor of Pyrogen. They have 14 tickets left to work with to the 37 of Meteor Makers.
Yeah, and you can just see for Pyrogen, know they're in the center of the map. They keep those spawns coming in, but every kill is counting right now. 33 tickets to 72, but the bleed is for Pyrogen. But there's only one left from Pyrogen, and that's Malicium. Everything is in trouble here. If he gets taken out, then that cap is coming in, and they're threatening a triple cap in the championships. And this is the last round, and they are in pole position. Then look at that full domination cap. What can Pyro do now?
Nothing. That's going to be it. Three tickets remaining. They have to fall down to 59. This will be over with two tickets, one more ticket to go. And that's going to be it. You can hear him on your headsets. That is Meteor Makers coming up big, coming back from being down a map the entire series to win it all. You can see what it means to them. They have been declining the entirety of all the cups, but to come out huge in the final moments. And the only thing that really mattered, the finals, as they finally got into it, they win the best of five against Pyrogen, who also has come out of nowhere and have done admirably this entire tournament.
The team that won the first Beta Cup has just won the first EMS.
Comes for a circle.
Yep. A team that everyone's been questioning, not won a championship in a long time, have just blitzed their way to the final and then had the hardest fight they have probably ever, ever encountered in Pyrogen.
I mean, both teams can honestly feel good about that. Both of them played so damn well. Meteor Makers just had that little bit of extra that they needed and pulled it back. And I mean, considering they lost the first map, they won the second barely, they lost the third map, they won the fourth barely, then they just completely stomped them on, well, not stomped, but it was probably the biggest victory that they had against them on Siege of Shanghai. I mean, it looks like Pyrogen just don't even know what happened right there. They knew they were so close. We were so close. My hair is soft, but we were so close.
They were so close so many times. That's the thing about it. They were taking...
Close doesn't cut it.
They took NYM to the limit every time.
Yes, they did, and fortunately for them, like I said before, close does not cut it, and Meteor Makers waiting to be crowned the victors. Congratulations yet again to them. Fantastic job. That was probably one of the best finals that we could hope for.
Yeah, that was crazy. They have done a great job for this tournament. Yes. They have been behind so many times. NYM have just made a fan of so many people with that performance, I'm sure. They just did the impossible so many times.
Yes, they did. And we definitely need to talk about the path they took to get here. So I'm just going to pull up the brackets just to make sure that I'm 100% right in these. But it was not easy for them. I mean, they took down ESC 2-0. And I'm checking out the next one. They lost to Fnatic 1-2. Oh, there we go. On the screen. Perfect. Thank you, guys. So they took down ESC. They lost to Fnatic. Then they had to play out through the loser side of it, where luckily for them, they came back against against Epsilon with a 2-1 win. Then to go on to play against UMAP and win in a 2-0, then to just come down to the end where 66% of the votes were for Pyrogen and 34% were for Meteor Makers to just pull out technically now an upset. So well played by them. And the thing is, they didn't have the easiest of times to get here in groups as well. They had to beat UMAP twice in groups to qualify.
Yeah, and I am totally in awe of NYM. They did a great job this tournament, but let's not take anything away from Pyrogen. They have upset so many big teams. Beat Dignitas twice, beat Fnatic, and...
Dignitas twice isn't easy. And then to beat Fnatic as well?
Yeah, and they didn't just beat Fnatic.
No.
They destroyed yes. Fnatic. They beat Fnatic so hard that some of the players don't even know if they want to keep playing. That's how hard they beat them.
That's a little harsh. That shows you how bad it was. But still, I mean, yeah, Pyrogen didn't get past the round of 16. A Cinderella story, unfortunately, has to come to a close here in the grand finals. But they can be damn proud of what they've done. I mean, the work they put in over the past couple of weeks has completely shown tenfold here now.
Yeah, and they're going to be haunted by how close they came. And they came
Looking at the scores. The thing is, you know, back in Operation Locker, four tickets. That's all it was. On Dawnbreaker, it was, if I can do my math correctly, 9 tickets. That's how damn close they were. If they just think, maybe if I won that 1v1 another time. Maybe if I didn't die in the beginning. Maybe if that one rush, that one push didn't work out. Maybe if I just defend that flag for a little bit longer. Maybe if I capped it a little bit quicker, this would have been a different story.
Welcome to Battlefield. That is how it works. Domination revolves around those individual moments of players going huge.
All right.
Both teams managed to have those players.
All right. Well, that's going to be it for us. Thank you very much for joining me, Dauber, as well. Thank you. A big thank you to Benson for joining us. Now, we're going to head over to Red Eye for the awards ceremony to crown our victors.
Thank you very much, gents, and thank you to all three of our commentators who've done a fantastic job over the weekend. It's been a really great weekend of Battlefield 4 action that we brought from EMS 1. We're now ready to crown our champions for the first ever EMS 1 Winter Championship for Battlefield 4. With me from DICE are Julian and Daniel, who are going to present the trophy and the winners and losers medals for our first and second place teams. Winning $5,000 and coming all the way through to a fantastic final. They couldn't quite keep the slipper on, but they were the perfect Cinderellas. Please welcome Pyrogen LDLC. Each of them will receive a silver medal. Well done. And did have a fantastic run through. It was fantastic. Well played. Gave you some great moments. And we'll remember their championship run through for a very long time. Well done. Put up a terrific fight, remember, through the regular season. This team didn't manage to get to the quarterfinals, yet here they are in the grand final at EMS 1, at the championship stage. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for our DLC Pyrogen. Okay, gents. Move over a little bit. Move over a little bit. There we go. Good lads. Let's go. Go. Thank you very much to Pyrogen. You have given us some fantastic memories, some fantastic moments over the last 2 days in Battlefield 4 that we definitely won't be forgetting in a very long time. Another team who came into this tournament as the ultimate dark horse. They were Dogbert's pick, no less, to win if Team Dignitas couldn't win. A team who have never, ever said no and always shown fantastic resilience through every single match, even to the fantastic five-map final that we had. Ladies and gentlemen, the champions of EMS 1 Battlefield 4 are MYM! €10,000 first prize, well done. And the gold medals. Julian handing out those gold medals right now. They are absolutely beautiful as well. Very memorable, they'll keep those forever. It's always difficult, isn't it? Head or handshake? Which one do you do first? Well done. And last two medalists. Safe will be the last man through to collect the trophy as well. He's going to get his gold medal from Julian. Daniel, do the honours. The EMS 1 trophy goes to Safe and goes to MYM. Ladies and gentlemen, the champions of EMS 1! Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Don't drop it now, Safe. Jeez, what would you know? That is it from EMS 1 in the Cologne studios here at VSL Studio 1. Thank you so much to all of the teams that have competed throughout the season, right from the A-Series, the Go4 Cups, and all the way through to the championship final. Congratulations to Pyrogen for the runners-up place, and thank you so much to the guys from DICE. But the last word is left for the champions. Ladies and gentlemen, MYM!